But also
Yeah,
your
really.
bangs are like right here.
Okay, hey everybody.
Well,
welcome to Guilty and D. We are back after a month and a half hiatus, and we have a lot to catch up with, especially my bangs that everyone is yelling at me about.
They're great.
I like them up
Oh,
here.
hell yeah.
I like them up here.
Just
This is
look them right all the way up.
They're the baby bangs. It's baby bangs. Okay, so here's the theory. Guys, I found a
It's a
picture on the
thing?
internet. Okay. So
Is it a thing? I'm asking genuinely. It's a thing?
No, it's definitely a thing.
Baby bangs are really in right now with hipsters. If you
in.
Go to Highland Park or Silver Lake even.
We all got
so,
ideas
with hipsters.
So I wanted to try it out.
Is it
so
maybe
I
in with babies? Is it?
No,
is
it's just. Okay, so anyway. Oh, I'm getting a lot of comments. Guys, I'm going to turn the comments off. But so basically, I wanted to, before I committed, I wanted to kind of test them out. And so I bought some fake bangs off Amazon for $9, and I've been testing out different links. Like, what about that? You like that, you guys?
I think that's really
that's
cute.
A good link.
But
yeah.
I was
good
the
question.
First to say, even the short ones, they look like Winona Ryder in Beetlejuice, and
yeah.
that's
yeah.
pretty great.
That is great.
It says they were popular in mood.
Wait, somebody in chat said they're popular in 2018. Okay, so I'm not going to look at chat.
Halloween's
anymore, so.
Coming up soon.
Oh boy.
Okay,
all
well,
right.
I'm going to take these
but
off.
But I'm glad we're all here.
I feel like I'm going to look at them and then later I'll see the stream and I'll be like, well, there was an animal on your head the whole time. So anyway,
oh,
thank you for your
okay,
opinion.
So it was a gag. Okay, I was confused.
No,
it
wasn't
it was
a gag though.
It's a wig.
It's fake, but it's not a gag.
No, it
okay.
wasn't a gag. I wanted to try out bangs before I committed to bangs. And then one of my mods on Discord reminded me of the 15 times I tweeted never get bangs again. So that was good. Anyway, hey guys. Hey guys, welcome to our stream. We're so excited to be back after a seven week hiatus. Let's forget about everything that happened before this video was edited down. We are thrilled to be back on a new 4-episode campaign. Just before I hand this over to Amy Vorphal, our wonderful DM, I would like to tell you guys that we do not have a sponsor for this run. So if you would like to support us, you can get a t-shirt. They did a reorder of them, Rolling with the Guild. Well, Cindy.
This is not the t-shirt.
That's not it. And we also have, for the first time ever, we are providing pins. So all 6 guild characters are below. As always, a portion of the profits of the shirt and the pin all go to No Kid Hungry, which is an amazing organization helping kids eat who might be underprivileged and can't get lunch because school is not in. So I think it's extra important to support charities like that. And so a portion of the pins and a portion of the shirt will go to them. And the rest will support the cast doing these awesome streams. So 4 more episodes and that's all I have. Let's forget all about that bang talk before. Amy, take it away, DM.
Yay, I'm so excited. We're playing again.
Yeah,
no.
What's happening, guys?
Yeah. I run out of things to tweet and do email. Anyway, I always use we. We! I feel like we don't say we enough. Like we're writing down a roller coaster. We!
Don't do that enough. We!
I'm not
doing that. Felt good. That was nice.
I'm going to incorporate that into my morning yoga.
Amy Okuda, I didn't hear you. I didn't hear you we.
Yeah. So, oh, you want to
do? Got a win, Amy.
I didn't hear Amy.
Oh, which Amy? Me?
Amy Okuda.
Oh, Amy Okuda, do it.
We.
Wow,
that sounds so
good.
French.
Yeah.
Your heart was in that.
Yeah. Exactly.
We.
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 So, I don't really have a recap because I just want to say go back and if you're new to this, you can always go back and watch all of the past streams that we've done. But there are just a couple of bullet points that I think will take up the exact amount of time that I need the audience to kind of remember. And maybe this will be a recap for the players as well of the things that you just need to know before you start playing today. Because there's some out of control, overpowered stuff that you guys have from last time, which is all canon. So first of all, Clarisil is the new party member. Clarisil is a non-binary. They're essentially Vork's blackhead / child. And they're enhanced by magic. And everyone last time at the very end, remember that you all felt that you were sleeping on how powerful they might be. You were very impressed by the amount of hit points they had. And now Blades almost died last time while everyone was focused on saving Clearasil, which is important to remember that on some level, maybe the party values Clearasil a little more than Blades.
It's not maybe. It's definitely not maybe.
And Blades actually is equipped with a sentient unitard made of a plant that offers immunity to damage from plants.
My sentient flowery unitard.
That's right. Blades, Clara and Zabu, your homeowners in the town of Bumble Hollow. Blades, remember you have a Gothic revival home. Clara, you have a Tudor style wizard's tower around one with Tudor thatch roof. And Zabu, yours is a craftsman style home. Clara, that apparently Jasper Never Muddy built for you after completing your very, very, very first quest in the town of Bumble Hollow. Clara, you have a wand of lightning bolts with sevenfold charges and an alchemy jug and a potion of growth, which all of those, I looked, they are all on your character sheet. Zabu is maybe the most changed person. Zabu is actually a zombie.
After, I forgot about that.
Yes, Zabu changed into a zombie after failing his save to attune to the wand of Orcus. So Zabu is now attuned to the Wand of Orcus, which, by the way, for any of you who do not play D&D, the Wand of Orcus is might be the most powerful magic item in the entire game. And if you need, don't worry about how they got it.
Works best when casted on yourself.
Yeah. Yes, Amy. Yes. Amy Akut. Yeah. Yes.
Sorry, Tink. Stole it from you.
Yeah.
No, just look straight down the barrel.
You did give it away. You felt that it should be in better hands, maybe with someone who respected it a little bit.
Better hands?
Wasn't going to point it at themselves.
Remember Zombu, the first spell you cast that is still Zombu. Active is you made 25 zombies and you had them just kind of party in your house. So
yeah.
They're there.
I kind of wanted them to, I wanted them to pay rent.
Right. So you basically have a small army of zombies. Tink, you have an e-bike, and which you, as you know, everyone, including Clearasil, is able to ride this. And other less important things from REI, and a huge sword called the Holy Avenger, which is again one of the powerful weapons in the game.
Oh boy.
Usually reserved for paladins, but this was a special. Don't worry about how they got it. They just Vork. You, as I said before, you have a child. You have two demon figurines, if you remember, male and female. Mm-hmm. From when you guys murdered the incubus that was in the spore tree.
Oh yeah.
And you found that on the incubus's body, along with a journal which Codex has. And you also kind of canon, take it or leave it, but it was towards the end of it was kind of established that your battle cries were things like "to whom it may concern, please," things that were very bureaucratic in nature. Codex, you have some new threads and new armor and a butt ton of overpowered spell scrolls, including a 9th level spell scroll, which is insane. Mm-hmm. The last thing to know is the crew, this guild, the Knights of Good, saved the fungal folk twice. First from a demon who was an incubus who was inhabiting their home tree called the spore tree. They killed the demon. And then they saved the fungal folk once more. They saved them from extinction by bringing them their trident back. That was about an hour away from Bumble Hollow, which is where we found them now. And where we left off, I guess this is the last thing. The guild, you have just learned that the homeowners of Bumble Hollow were subject to Bumble Hollow's soul tax, in which a demon comes to collect one soul from the town every year. And that was very distinctly and specifically neglected from Thrashen, who's the mayor of Bumble Hollow, the mayor shaman. She never told you that, and you found out that information from one of the mushrooms, cinnamon. So,
really quick question, Vorpy. Am I still also infected or cursed of the werebear?
Yes. Oh my gosh. I don't. Okay. yes, there's a lot to go through, but absolutely, you are, right. Yes, you have the curse of the werebear. You are a werebear. Yeah, you are. You're a werebear. So, so TBD on what that, on what the change, like
when we'll see how it shakes happens. Out. I'm sure it'll be fine.
But you, yeah, you are afflicted.
And we're all, and we're all out of the game. We're all level 4 now. So we all leveled.
Yes. Everyone leveled up one level. And the last thing I want, I keep saying that, but I do want to shout out a YouTube comment from the stream. This is from Verp Lord. Whomever set up this camera layout, who did female, male, female, male, female, male, DM on the bottom or DM in the center is my hero and placed on my balance and equilibrium paranoia like a god. Psst, I get you. So that's just a shout out to the lovely Sean Funny. Becker, who is organizing.
Wow, Becker, great job, man.
Yay, Sean Becker. Yeah,
you're making OCD people very happy, I guess.
Making us look good.
Yeah.
Real quick, can I? Yeah. I just want to make a plea because we rolled a new character for me, right? I'm Zombo now.
Yep.
So I just want to make a plea to our audience because I have a 1-year-old baby, so I don't really have time to come up with like a good icon for my guy. So if anybody wants to take my existing Zabu icon and zombify it,
that would be awesome.
Maybe we choose a winner and chuck him a t-shirt. I don't know, something like that.
Yeah, no, we can give them. You know what? I have some signed guild stuff in my storage unit, and I will. We'll give you. It's a signed poster with all of us signing it, and I don't know what I'll get it for to you, but I will get it to you. Okay.
Better than a t-shirt.
Send in those zombies.
Oh, I almost threw them out. I was like, what am I going to do with these? And I saved them because I'm a hoarder. Hey!
but yeah, to that point, you'll see that Zabu has, or Zabu Zombu, they've got, he's got a little bit more, just a nuanced character sheet if you are clicking on the character sheet. And that's just because...
Oh my God, Sandy.
otherwise, I'll just use this Indian zombie that I found via Google search.
Google Indian zombie?
Yes, I did.
It was the first thing that came up. You're like, that's fine.
Hilarious. No, it's pretty spot.
That will do.
That is scary. Yeah,
that's some good teeth right there. Okay, so any other questions? That was a lot. From you guys? No. All right, then let's move on.
Yeah.
I don't know about that journal. I don't remember anything about the journal, hopefully.
Right. So in the very, very first episode when you guys defeated the incubus, you asked, isn't there a journal where we never, you were all of you were like, oh yeah, we never talked to this guy to figure out what his deal was. He attacked us, so we attacked him. Uh-huh. And you actually did retrieve a journal from him where he was bellyaching.
I remember that. He was complaining a lot. But
he was complaining a lot.
Yeah,
and he wrote down his size like that. And his main thing was that he couldn't get higher in court. So he was trying to find new ways of seducing people.
Okay, great. Yeah, thank you.
And that's what you found. So, whew, with all that said, after you all took a break to deal with some logistical stuff back in Mondopolis, including Fox and Codex's gossipy neighbor, Ruthie.
Oh my God.
All of you traveled.
Oh, Ruthie.
You all traveled back to Bumble Hollow with the intent to find out a little bit more about what this curse is, how you guys got involved, and with the intent to confront Thrashen Cedar Pal. So that's where we do find you. All together, you do approach Bumble Hollow, which if you remember, it's a literal grassroots town. Most of its 20 buildings are huts built with wood, clay, sticks, and leaves. Some are even teepee-like. And you do remember where the Mayor Shaman's hut is, and it's just got a whole bunch of trinkets and baubles and homeopathic medicines, alchemical reagents, things that hang from the ceiling and inside and outside, and a makeshift campfire inside. So there's smoke billowing from the top of her little hut. You can tell me where you want to go, if you want to go directly there, or if you want to check out your houses and check out your zombies, whatever, but you kind of have the run of the place. If you also remember, there is a person you never encountered, which is Jasper Nevermuddy. And he was the guy who apparently was tasked in building your houses, which, if come to think of it, he did build them rather quickly.
Do you guys want to check out the houses while we're here?
If you guys want my Indian zombies, they make really good chai.
I would love some chai, actually.
Let's do it.
And how are 25 of them living in your small hut? Which, by the way, you might lose your soul because you have it. Hey, raise hands who got the gold instead of the house? Hey.
I think I got the gold.
I'm still proud of my decision. My house is beautiful.
Okay, no.
Yeah, you'll be happy about that when your soul gets sacrificed.
I'm not worried.
Mine's a craftsman. I'm pretty psyched.
Okay, can we please?
Gothic revival, look at those banisters.
Yes, lots of points on yours. Lots of points.
Look how pointy my house is.
Mm-hmm. It's really nice.
So, okay. Hey, where are y'all headed?
Make everybody some tea.
We should listen. You know what we should do? We should invite that Jasper Honey Muddy, Jasper Funny Muddy, whoever that guy Jasper is, to come over for some chai and pump him for information, right?
I love it.
Yeah, let's pump Jasper.
Yeah.
Okay, so who's gonna go? Tink or Clara, go get Jasper to come to Zabu's house.
Or can Tink just like shoot a message via Era? Maybe he'll just come over.
Yeah.
Got it. Speaking of shooting a message, the one other thing that I forgot is that you all remember had tiny mushrooms sacrifice themselves so that you could all be linked by tiny beads.
Oh yeah.
You have a link to each other now as long as you're wearing.
Oh, we have those special beads, so we can like telepathically talk to each other.
Yes, and they suggested even at some point maybe you could teleport to one another.
Ooh. Okay,
so really don't even talk to each other.
I didn't want to be close to you guys like that, but that's fine. Clara or Tink, just go get this Jasper guy and bring him to Zabu's zombie tea room.
Oh yeah,
I'm already drinking tea, so Clara, you go.
Okay. Well, just so we get the image of what's in Zombo's house, it is not furnished yet. He definitely built the house, but there's nothing really in there except for the zombies, and they do like
the zombies are happy. Yeah. Sorry, the zombies are happy to be furniture for you. So
okay,
or is he sitting on like an assemblage of like armchair zombies?
Yeah.
Could you make a chaise lounge for me? Thank you.
Absolutely. Yeah, Raj, can you chase it up? Thank you so much.
Great.
Okay,
yeah, I'm good.
It just so you know, it does stink of rotting flesh, but
no, we're, that's how it was anyway before the zombies got there.
I pull an arm on the side of the armchair, and one more zombie pops out from the bottom. Pull my feet up.
Zombie recliner.
Amazing. I'm gonna go on the porch and enjoy my chai.
Same. I'll be standing outside.
Okay, perfect. So Clara, I guess are you the one who's gonna go get Jasper?
Sure. Yes, I'll go get Jasper.
Okay, awesome. His house, I mean, his house was pointed out to you early on by Thrashen, and she was very enamored with Jasper, and she kept wanting to bring him into the situation with you guys, but you never took the bait, and you kind of went on the mushroom adventure without ever really meeting him. But she did point out the direction of where his house is, so you know exactly where it is. It's another craftsman style kind of hut slash house, and it's very well built, very well crafted, very precise, way, 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 even more pristine than Zabu's. And it's towards the back of the, it's away from the shaman hut, and it's towards the back of the town, almost a little bit isolated. So you walk up, and it doesn't look like anybody's home. There's no lights, there's no smoke coming out like there was in Thrashen's hut.
Okay, so I'm gonna maybe knock again and see what's happening.
Okay, great. Hey. What do you say?
I just say hello.
Okay.
Hey.
Do a perception check real quick.
Okay.
Okay.
Like if I were to do that, like what?
Sorry. Roll a d20.
Yeah. Thank you.
And look at your character sheet, and in the middle there are a bunch of skills.
Right.
Like,
I got asking for a friend. I got 13.
A 13. Okay. You get the feeling that you're not alone right now, but you can't really tell what's going on, and you don't, there's nothing kind of appears from the house.
Weird. Okay. Should I go in? I think I'm going to go in.
Okay. How are you trying to go
in? I'm just going to open the door.
Yeah, it opens. Yep.
Oh my gosh.
All right.
Okay.
And then I just stand, the door, you know, opens and I'm just like, Jasper, are you there?
Yeah. And as soon as you open it, so this is what you see. You've got a tiny little foyer to the left of a dining area, to the right, kind of a sitting room. And then as it moves forward, there's a big open room that's both the kitchen to the left and a living room to the right. It looks like past the living room are bedrooms behind there. There is a staircase up and the staircase is to your right and it goes up and then there is a door under the staircase. But that's not what catches your eye. What really catches your eye is towards the back of the house, you see a figure just kind of slink out.
Ugh, no.
Oh, were you gonna say something?
No, I just, she can contact any of us at this point, anytime she wants to, correct?
That's right, yeah. You know that you've tried it out and you can 100% telecommunicate. The teleporting, I don't know if you've tried it out, but it doesn't seem to work as well, if at all. I'll just say it hasn't worked yet, but the telecommunication, it's as if you guys can use the message spell whenever you want, which is, it has no distance range. It even goes across planes and it just means you can telecommunicate.
Gotcha.
Okay. So I'm going to head. So the little slinky figure slinks out of the house.
Yeah. It's a tall figure and you can see a lot of brown skin. It looks like about 6'5".
I wonder what humanoid. Clara's doing right now.
Yeah, you guys. So, okay, so that little slinky thing leaves, and I'm like, everyone else is drinking tea. I'm going to head to the kitchen and make myself a little cocktail. and then I say, guys, that little slinky thing slinked away. Should we go chase it? Should we go look for it?
Slinky? What? Does the guy have slinkies? What's going on?
I don't know. That's
Claire,
how I'm.
Claire, you know we're not in the house with you, right?
Yeah, but I'm like messaging you guys.
Oh, okay, cool. I'm just trying
to describe the slinky thing, Claire. Can you do like a nature check or an arcana check?
Should you really be making tea in a stranger's kitchen?
It's a cocktail.
I just saw some mead. Actually, I saw mead, so I'm just going to pour myself.
Claire, are you in danger? What is Claire, the slinky thing?
You guys told me to come here by myself, and I don't know what else to do except.
Do you want me to head over?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Why are you leaving? I'm going now.
You entered a strange person's house. You saw a suspicious creature, and you just went to make a cocktail. Is that really your go-to?
Yes.
I'm gonna send a couple zombies over as well. So if you're gonna head over, Raj and Shaythal are gonna join you.
I was just checking for change in the zombies' couches.
Could we all
so
go?
I'm fine to go.
You were checking their couches or their crotches.
I set my tea down on the zombie coffee table and get up and head out as well.
Let's just go. I'm going to go too. We should never send Clara alone anywhere. What were we thinking?
That was you.
Why would we do that? You said Clara. So I was doing something.
Clara. In your head, you said you make cocktails. So I would bet that this guy's got some alcohol in his house. Are you making the cocktail with alcohol from this guy's house? Are you making it from your alchemy jug? And what kind of cocktail are you making?
I checked out he doesn't have a good array of spirits. So I pull out my little alchemy jug and lo and behold, there is some wine in it. So okay. We're not going to go to cocktails. We're just going to wine. If we do have to go. Yeah. I feel like wine.
You already been chipping away at that?
So what are you drinking? Are you
just drinking some wine?
So you didn't actually plunder his.
I didn't like what I saw.
Alcohol. Okay. Got it. Okay. Cool. I just needed to know that. So so do you all head over to the Jasper house?
Yeah,
because we don't know what's going on over there. Like, what is Slinky? What is going on?
Push it to the back door, though. That's where I want to start.
You want to start there? Okay, you so actually, Blades, go ahead and roll a perception check yourself.
You like that?
All right, great. Oh, boy.
Is anyone going the back way with
me? I'm going to go in the back way. I'm going to go in the back door.
Okay. Yep. So
it's worked out for me in the past.
We're all back door.
All of you can roll.
I'll go in the front door. I don't give a shit.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, I don't want to go the back way either.
I'm going to go in the front door. I mean,
I'm guessing Clara didn't even close
the door. We got a double team this house.
Really Clara is going to the front door. I assumed that you guys would follow. So
we can't do anything as a group. Not one thing.
So, once again, Vince and I are going the back way where we never didn't take any damage for that whole fight in the townhouse. And you guys can all go for the front door.
I'm going the back door. I'm changed, okay? I'm all the way back door. I want back door every time.
I'm going to go in the bathroom window.
For sure. Let's put that on the t-shirt.
The bathroom window.
Please tell me it's too small to get through. My perception check was 14.
Okay, and I'll say Zabu and Codex and Blades. Yeah, roll a perception or a survival check since you know that you're looking kind of for a figure.
Roll the 12.
Well, I rolled a 9 on both. Wait,
okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Am I rolling?
No, just the folks that were. Yeah, I mean, you guys are keeping an eye out, but in the
front. I rolled something really good right now, so. Just
what did you roll, T?
What
I thought we were all rolling a perception check, so I got a 23.
Okay. Wow. You got it? What? You got a 23?
23.
Okay, you perceive? You have this feeling just deep in your soul that, God, maybe you should have gone the back way.
Yes. Oops. Well perceived.
Well perceived. You made the wrong choice.
No, what a waste of rule.
But the folks in the back, so Blades, you can see that whoever slinked off, they weren't really covering their tracks. They just they kind of left in a hurry, and they went a little bit deeper into the forest past Bumble Hollow's actual boundaries.
Uh-oh. God, somebody just, the slinky.
They took off into the forest, guys.
We gotta go. Guys, okay, I'm gonna, guys, there's an AWOL, A-W-A-L, person of interest, P-O-I. It's a P-O-I, that's A-W-A-O-L. What?
don't anachronize. A-M.
I'm trying to.
See,
curious in your head. What are you doing?
What's happening?
We're all next to each other as well.
Shouldn't we
check the whole house first?
Vorpy, did we see them? That slinky guy run past us from the back door? Is that what you said? Or
no. Blades was the first one back there, and yeah, he immediately sees like, someone definitely left through here. I could probably follow him if I wanted to. But no, you didn't see anything. Be clear, Clara, the thing you saw was definitely a humanoid. You could see a lot of their skin showing, at least on their torso. Brown skin, about 6'5", muscly.
Why don't we do this? Why don't the three of us that went the back way try to track this guy while the rest of you guys search the house?
Search the house. Yeah, that's a good idea.
Is there any call for searching a strange person's house when they aren't? When they aren't in their house, we don't know if any foul play has happened.
Better than when they're home.
Wait a second, you're the one that sent Robin to go look at it by herself.
Listen.
I said go get a person to invite them to tea, and now we're B&E inside, and we have an AWOL, POI.
We've come this far.
Somebody could be hurt.
What's B? Oh, breaking and entering.
Thank you. We're going to get guys.
We've already B'd and E'd. Let's just see it through.
I'm going to track. I want to track. I have a high survival skill, so I'm going to track.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so y'all three, but just so you know, the people in the house, the two zombies that sort of were trying to obey Zabu's orders, they did make it into the house, and two of them are examining the furniture and kind of going, oh, you could be a better table. Look at that.
They're learning something. That's great.
Softer cushion. How I make softer cushion with bones.
Yeah.
So they're
very full of themselves. They're very full. They are very proud of their furnituring.
Yeah. Okay. So let's split y'all in half. Group one, the trackers. All three of you, Blade, Zabu, and Codex, roll a survival check.
14.
Here it comes. Are you ready? Also 14.
A natural 9.
Okay. Yeah. So, I mean, even with that, that you are able to track him. He wasn't really, I'll say that he wasn't covering his tracks. So you definitely see he's moving northeast. And if you remember, the tree is west of the town. So he's moving northeast, and it seems like he's kind of just lumbering along, like nothing's, no twigs are broken, really. It's just kind of the footsteps themselves are a little heavy, and he's kind of trudging through the soft dirt and moss and grass of the forest.
Let's pursue.
Yeah.
Does he look like he's like,
to do that, huh?
You said he's stumbling. Does he look like he's injured, or that he's
his footsteps are heavy, but they don't favor one foot over the other, and there I imagine you're looking out for blood, and there's no real blood. Okay. The other crew, tell me where you're searching.
Well, first of all, I rolled a 24 already.
What?
Okay.
So for whatever.
You can't just pocket something.
Whatever you're about to do, I rolled a 24. So whatever.
Wow, you can't just pocket.
Lord, fuck off.
No, that's okay. Just not even. No,
he's making fun of Amy. He's making fun of Amy.
I'm making fun of Amy.
Oh, great.
Okay.
Perfect. Okay,
so Amy, Clara, and Vork, tell me whereabouts you're searching. Remember, there is an upstairs and then also a door under the staircase.
I'll go upstairs.
Well, let's stick together. I think we should stick together. Let's go.
Wow.
Let's all go upstairs.
Okay.
You just want to see if there's more alcohol.
Yes.
Okay. Amy, do you concur?
Just yeah, I'll go upstairs. Why not?
All right, so now all of you can roll a, I'd say an investigation check, because you are looking, I imagine you're looking for something just out of the ordinary, or at least information.
And just ask if we're a friend, that's 20-sided?
Sorry, yes, a 20-sided die. It has been 6 weeks, and sorry. A lot, I
just
know
use
a lot
your
of
character
played D&D does... before. But yeah, you roll a
D&D Beyond is really easy for this.
I got 16.
Dang, okay.
I got a, what is a B?
That's a 20.
Okay. Oh. I've never rolled these dice.
You got a 20.
Yes, D&D Beyond has a B for the 20s place.
Oh, it's already working out for me. This...
Look at you.
I just think it's funny to put grades on dice, like A plus, A. I got a B.
Not bad.
Yeah, you did
all right. Oh, it says it right here on the right. Sorry.
Guys, I rolled a 1600 on my SATs.
Okay, so actually that would be really good for Zabu's guild character. That'd be good for his mom to play with him. Roll the D&D academics game, son. Okay, so...
Oh, I'm sorry. It's 21, actually. I had plus one.
Oh, nice. Okay. So, Amy, Tink, you all see a couple of rooms. There's a bedroom to the left that kind of overhangs the living room, and then another room to the right. Amy, you go into the bedroom, and it's very four-poster bed, end tables. You do find some like personal stuff, but it doesn't look out of the ordinary. It looks like
what
just
kind
normal
of personal stuff?
Like you find some Dirty Elf magazines.
Ooh. Dirty yeah. Elf man.
Okay, I put that in my elf purse.
What do you take him?
I take
play elf.
Yeah, play elf. and then toothbrushes and other. Actually, in the bathroom of the master bedroom, you do find some a lot of grooming materials. But they seem like granola, crunchy, musky, like organic deodorant type. Materials.
Oof. It's like one of those salt cube things.
Yeah, like don't it's not work. Like it's not going to clog your pores. You know,
don't work.
Yeah. And
is it like women's stuff or is it like men's stuff?
Oh, good question. It's men's stuff.
Men's stuff.
But the other two, you two, kind of get a little bit more intrigued with the door to the right, and it isn't too hard, Vork. You could easily force it open with your strength. And with your two scores, you're able to see that this room, I mean, there's like nothing in this room except a chalk circle on the floor.
No elf magazines?
There's no, I'm so sorry.
A chalk circle?
A chalk circle.
Yeah, with little insignias like and a star drawn inside it.
Can you do perception or something or to figure out what it is?
Well, I mean, you guys, you know that it's a summoning circle.
Okay, I didn't know.
But if you two roll religion, maybe you could determine which.
Okay.
Do you do that?
13. Mm-hmm.
16. Oh my god, 16. This is plus, I'm sorry, 16 minus 15.
You have a minus one?
I have a minus one.
I do too.
Okay, so
it's really bad at religion, huh?
Yeah,
it's a Jewish thing.
Because you're Scientologist.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Okay. Clara, you can tell that this is evil, which is pretty normal and what you would expect. But you, Vork, kind of seem to remember in your fighting days when you were maybe considering being a paladin and you had to choose a deity and you decided against that in the first place. But you do remember researching some deities, and this is a ring or a summoning circle to Baphomet, or with Baphomet's insignia kind of all.
Oh my.
And he, this guy's, he's a prince. He's the demon lord of Minotaur. So he favors ugly beasts. Ugly in D&D, real wretched beasts, I guess.
They're gonna love you, Vork.
Wow.
Love Vork. Wow. May love.
This is the one with the bangs.
But a lot of misshapen creatures like ogres and giants and other lots of savage bestial. I mean, honestly, were beasts like were bears or were boars might be predisposed to follow this guy too. Yeah.
Scary.
Yeah, you can also tell, I guess, with a 16. Yeah, no, that's what you know.
Okay.
Yeah, are there any other questions that you're like looking for?
What do you think, Robin? Should we?
I don't know, Vork. What do you think, Vork?
What are you guys there for?
You can call it.
I think we should keep on going.
Robin.
I think we should keep this in mind, but also go finish exploring.
You know what? Let's keep it in mind and let's continue exploring.
And I'm telling you right now, there's something weird here. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, no, there is something weird going on. But I, Amy, you two, since I imagine you guys told her about what you found, but all y'all roll an insight check, I guess.
Insight.
I mean, is that 24?
Saving that for a rainy day.
I got a 4. That was not good.
Oh my god. I am having so much. I have a 19 plus 20.
Wow.
20. Wow.
Nice. Is it awesome. plus one? Yeah, 20.
Vork's on it.
Vork, when you say, oh, something weird's going on here, absolutely something weird is going on here. But the weirdest thing of all is how unhidden this is.
Yes,
right?
It was right.
This guy's clearly summoning something. Shouldn't his door be locked? Shouldn't this be in the basement? Shouldn't there, I don't know, be some precautions taken? Shouldn't he have been bounding out of here if he was running away? Was he running or was he just walking? Like the perceived notion that this should be a hidden kind of entanglement situation that's what's rubbing you the wrong way.
Yes, all these things you're telling me I should be thinking.
Yes. Everything here is very manifest and out in the open.
Basically just straight logic. She's just giving you...
You rolled high on common sense.
Okay. Yeah, it's out in the middle of nowhere.
You're a smart guy, and I just want to make sure that you're as smart as you actually are.
I don't think you know me very well.
TV.
I actually don't think we're that close, actually. I don't think you're aware of my history.
Team B, what's your ETA? What's your stat?
Who the heck is Team B?
You house guys are Team B.
Yeah, why aren't we A?
Oh, we're
pursuing Jasper, so obviously we're Team A.
Yeah, like what do you mean it's dangerous? We could be.
I thought Clinicel was Team A.
We found something very strange.
Hey, you guys, I got an issue of Elf Boy.
Whether it's Play Elf or Elf Boy, I'm down for both.
I'll sell it to one of you guys later, okay?
Okay, that's awesome, Tate. But what did Vork say was kind of suspicious over there?
Suspicious is we found a demon summoning circle that's right out in the open, apparently.
Okay.
And I thought of that all myself. It's weird. It's out in the open. There's no locks. There's no it's not in the basement.
It seems kind of obvious to think that though.
What is it worshiping? Did you do like did you see any indications?
What was it for Robin?
Baphomet? Was that
Baphomet?
It?
Yeah.
Baphomet?
Yeah. I like how Baphomet. You tried to ask me. I was listening.
Come on.
Amy, Vorpy, as a warlock, does Baphomet ring a big bell for me? Or?
No. The demon, well, I mean, no, not really.
I'm going to do a religion check.
You have a packed demon, but Baphomet. You wouldn't have any. Baphomet's like a deity, just like an evil deity.
Oh, gotcha, gotcha.
Deity. Yeah. So your demon would be more like a tomfoolery kind of guy. I don't know, like a knight in a court kind of thing.
Just a silly guy.
Wacky.
Yeah. Well, not wacky and silly,
a
but
zany kind of dude.
Like a
tomfoolery.
Yeah. Okay. Got a good sense of humor, not like deity.
Hey, can we? Is it back on us now? Can we like talk to this?
Yeah, back on Team A. Yeah.
Thank you.
It's
Thank
canon.
Confirmed.
Thanks for
confirmed.
I like that.
Sorry,
there,
I know.
A.
Sorry.
Wow. So,
but yeah. So y'all are following him, and you come. You do. What's your question first, Zabu?
Oh, yeah, I wanted to sort of like sneak up and try to get a better look, see if he looks threatening.
Yeah, so you do get a sense that maybe like as he's slowly walking, he does he's still heading the direction. I guess he doesn't really slow down. So, but you do start hearing him. So you are able to, I guess, roll a stealth check. Everyone who's trying.
Oh yeah, definitely. Oh, be sneaky.
That sounds like a good thing for Bladesy over there. I got 15.
Oh, 15. 23. 15.
Nice, y'all. Okay, yeah, you're definitely able. So I'll just say that you can do whatever you want. I'll tell you what you see, and then yeah, you can remain undetected for as long as you wish.
Got it. Okay.
This guy, he's got. You see him come into a clearing, and you see him. He's not what's spectacular about what you see, but what you do see is he's got long wavy hair, very full of kind of a Neanderthal face, but it's kind of attractive, like a long forehead and a jutted up jaw, big lips, like a furrowed brow, an eternally furrowed brow, muscular as heck, definitely 6'5", tan olive skin, and just wearing a loincloth. And some leather shoes, and
some Hirachis are short.
That's a very handsome caveman.
He's a very handsome caveman. This is Jasper. Well, it's Jasper and
Jason Momoan
is kind of
very Jason Momoan.
That was like an Easter Island head come to life. Sexy.
Yes. but yeah, speaking of Easter Islanders, there's a door made out of stone. That seems to be decaying, but never quite ends the decay. So it's like, it's disappearing and it's gray and it's, there's no moss or anything that's green growing on it or around it. While the forest was lush and green, there's about a 20-foot radius circle around this portal that where everything's dead. Maybe there's some beetles, bugs and stuff that maybe shouldn't even be around there, little long centipedes with horns, that type of stuff. And the portal, you've never really seen a portal before, but this portal looks dead, if you had to guess. And there is another figure that is about 10 feet tall. So he's bigger. And he walks in from the other side of the clearing.
It's Jason Momoa on the Rock.
he is very, very less attractive. So this guy, This guy looks like every single part of his body is like a tree stump. He doesn't have a neck. He's kind of got a skullish face and spines like on him. And he's got humanoid hands. And he seems to favor skulls in his.
He's got a lot going on.
Maybe I'll yeah.
Guys, I'm thinking we they
he kind of looks like a shaved. He kind of looks like a shaved. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
I was just gonna say that. Like, is there any reason that we need to engage these giants?
Listen, I don't think we should engage. We should eavesdrop and see what they're talking about. Because by the way, one of your souls, the people who are dumb and invested in the real estate market, one of your souls might be repossessed. To hell, okay?
Yeah, that's, I don't know about that.
What are the chances that it'll be us?
I'm going to do a nature check. Can I do an arcana check on that guy or a nature check?
I wanted to do an arcana check.
Samesies.
Okay, nature or arcana would do
it. I'm equally bad at both. Let's try
21
this.
Arcana.
Whoa. 21 arcana.
Yeah, that's 20.
Hey, y'all.
Nice
job.
Wow. So,
I got a B.
You got a B? Wait, really?
Yeah, I got a B.
On the die?
Yeah.
Is that a 20?
That is a 20.
Okay, all right. I don't know where the jokes end, you know, and the reality begins.
This is going to be infuriating for people who don't love D&D. I'm so sorry.
Do you care about D&D and the rules? Don't watch this. Yeah.
This is not for you.
The wrong place.
Yeah, so y'all know that this is 100% what D&D would call a fiend, which is another word for a devil or a demon. This one in particular is hella strong, but he's not a king or an archduke of the underworld or a knight of the underworld. He's still a lackey, but he's in the underworld. They're just insanely strong. So fiends are out of control, big and bulky. And it's a 21.
Are they doing any, are they like doing a ritual or anything? Or is there anything?
Well, yeah, you haven't seen them interact yet. No, if you sit and wait for a little while, or he does approach Jasper and he goes, well, I guess I'm here. It's soul collecting day.
Soul collector.
And Jasper says, follow me. Did you examine the boundary of Bumble Hollow? And the big demon goes, yes, I found it to be to my liking. The boundary is acceptable. The demon king would love to hear. I best be on my way, though. I never like staying on this plane longer than I need to, Jasper. And Jasper goes, quite, I understand. We have some recruits for you. Lead the way. And Jasper turns back to go to his house, back the way he came.
Get out! TB, get out of the house right now. A demon is coming.
Get out of the house.
Get out of the house now.
The girl is coming from inside the house.
But their bed is so nice. It's really comfortable.
No, there is a fiend coming too. It is soul collecting day. Get the F out of there.
Let's get out.
Okay, well, let's
go. We're about to get some in half.
Where should we go?
I've got better elf porn at my house.
Get out of the house. What do you mean? Where
Wait, should I leave the play elf or?
Oh boy!
No! Bring the play elf. Bring the play elf.
It's already in your satchel. Okay. I'm bringing it. Okay.
Just
okay.
Get out. Right, let's don't, go. Do not.
We're leaving.
Front door.
Go
the front door and then go the opposite way of the house because the fiend is coming. The way that we came.
Okay.
Scatter.
Okay.
Should we meet at the mayor's house and ask him what's going on? Or
yeah, maybe.
Let's rendezvous at the mayor's house.
No, behind the mayor's house, not as the front door, because the fiend could be going to the mayor's house.
Okay.
I'm going through the front door.
Okay, Jesus.
No, I'm just kidding. Let's do the.
You're backup. You're the guild leader. Okay, I'm okay. Sorry.
Let's go.
Get it. You like missionary? We get it.
There it is.
I just want you to get it. I've been hinting at it all these years.
Yeah. Okay. So we run. We want to meet with them before the fiend gets there.
So okay, cool. So you're
all ASS.
Cool. You kind of get a little head start, and you did roll really high for your stealth. So you don't. Yeah, you're able to kind of run through the brush and not on the main path. Get to your friends and make it a little bit kind of southwest to where the mayor shaman's hut is. The smoke is still billowing out of her hut. What do you want to do as you approach there?
Did anybody bring my zombies?
How about you?
I wonder if they count as souls.
I think we left
them. Can we just like give them one of the zombies?
Yeah, maybe just have them.
I'm thinking people can't tell Indian zombies apart. So maybe if they come after me, I'll just send one of those guys down
terrible
here.
Terrible thing to say.
I mean, I can tell them apart. I can totally.
I think we all can, right. Although we don't want to look at them because their fates are rot. But they're all rotting in a unique way. So yeah, it's a unique rotting. Okay, that's fine.
That's cool. I was worried okay, great.
What are we going to do, guys? They said we have some new recruits for you. That means they're going to pick from one of the three of you to possess your soul.
Yeah, does it really matter for us, Codex, though? Because like, they're not going to pick us, so... Should we just go have some more tea or?
Jasper said we have some new recruits for you. Okay. No tea for you. Exactly. Thank you.
I mean, I feel like it's one for all and all for one here. So.
All right. So maybe we should go. Should we talk to the mayor? What happened out of this?
Yeah. Let's talk to them.
Wait. I'd like to. Do I know anything about soul possession? Will they like take? What do I know about soul possession? I'm gonna roll an arcana check.
Okay, let's see if any of you. I'll just say this is straight up intelligence.
Okay, great.
So everyone can try to
Oh boy, I'm definitely dumber.
So we're gonna do an intelligence
dose,
or just use our intelligence.
Wait, intelligence one at the top.
Yeah, so roll a d20 and then don't add your any skills, but just add the number
above the intelligence. Yeah, okay.
I'm not very smart.
18. 18. 18.
Okay.
9. 11.
I got 7.
I got 2, so.
Yeah. Okay. So really just Codex. Which would make sense as a cleric to have some knowledge of how healing and resurrection and that kind of thing works, because there are souls involved. You know that souls, in theory, the way you studied medicine and healing and channeling a deity, that souls are, when they're with the body, they're pretty incorporeal and you can't really see them or feel them. But when they're taken out, they do become their own kind of thing. Corporeal, they can be sentient, once someone dies, their soul goes into another plane of existence, and in that plane they survive in a way, and it's normally considered a pretty evil place where the souls live.
So if one were to repossess the soul in the quote unquote lottery, they would kill the person and then take their soul, or would they walk around without a soul? Like how?
You haven't really seen that happen. You've only seen people die.
Uh-huh.
And there was no real soul to be seen on the material plane. So
well,
you never
either
really
way, it sounds bad.
It.
Yeah.
But you know, in theory that if a person dies, yeah, their soul kind of appears in a different evil plane.
Oh gosh.
I mean, like, what's holding us here? Should we just run the Ethel out of here? Like, should we just
seriously, why do
town?
We need to stay here? Yeah.
They've got to have some kind of magic that will come after us.
We can sell our houses, right?
But you have houses here.
Oh,
yes.
Let's
talk to you right now.
Let's go to the mayor. Let's go to the mayor and try to sell our houses, like, as quickly as possible.
Yes, let's do it right there. Okay,
yeah, it's a seller's market right now. So let's do this.
One cent. I mean, just whatever. We'll get whatever we can get.
Like, do you have to even sell it? Why do we have to sell it?
Just give someone the key.
We need to get, we need to like, you know, officially be.
There's paperwork. That's right.
But I guess. Okay. Yeah.
No, demons respect bureaucracy.
Yeah. Closing costs are up.
Well, it seems to, because just by holding a house in Bumble Hollow, Cinnamon said that you're eligible for the soul tax. So yeah, bureaucracy is definitely appreciated by demons. Y'all
do some paperwork.
Yeah. Are y'all running into the mayor's hut?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
So it's just as you left it, fire burning, Thrashen's in the back. She turns around and she looks at you in her very non-confrontational, afraid of confrontation, in fact, manner. And she says, "Oh, hey, I'm so glad you're here. Good to see you. How are your houses treating you?
How are our houses? How are they treating us?
Oh,
you guys didn't tell us about the soul tax when we purchased the house. Okay,
totally.
Stack of papers to sign for closing costs, and didn't mention anything about soul tax. I think that the contract is null and void.
I know. Wait.
Yeah. So we guys don't want to like disclose.
Yeah.
It was failure to disclose the issues with the house. Like, so that's.
I mean, on my end, there are no real issues, but I see what you're saying. Just give me 1 second. Everybody roll initiative.
Okay, that's it.
What? Oh, let's stop this, mayor.
Oh my gosh, she's going to attack us. She's attacking us.
I got a nat 20 for initiative.
Okay.
Buckle up. I don't want to go first. Oh, no.
She just stab her in the face.
Buckle up, I defer.
okay, did anybody get 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 10 to 15?
Yeah.
I got 11.
I got 11 as well.
Okay, we'll say Zava goes first, and then Clara, and then 5 to 10.
Amy, Akudo, we can't hear you.
Oh, I got a 21.
Dang. Wow.
Okay, girl, you go.
Okay, Tink, and then Zabu, and then Clara. Anyone get a 5 to 10?
I got a 7.
Okay. Uh-oh.
Can you just say you go, girl, again?
Codex, what did you get?
3.
Got a 3. So I guess Blades, you're first in this initiative. What you see is she goes, just give me 1 second. And turns her back to you and grabs something from the wall that you can't really see.
Oh my God.
Okay. So what I want to do is I want to just draw my rapier.
Okay.
And I want to hold it at her. And I want to just say, hey, let's just talk about this. Okay. And hold my action in case she attacks or displays aggression, in which case then I will attack her with the rapier.
Okay. Cool. So you're holding action. The trigger will be if she attacks. Great.
Yes.
Tink?
Can I just attack?
Absolutely.
Oh, my God. Fuck me, right?
Like, shoot the thing out of her hand.
I know. Okay, yeah, okay. Look. I will take, I just want to, like, scare her a little bit. So I don't really want to, like, hit her. But, like, you know, maybe I just want to, like, take my dagger and just, like, you know how like those gangsters kind of like
from the table.
Snap, but like through their hand.
Oh, wow.
Don't want to hurt her.
Yeah.
So it won't kill her, but it just like shakes her up a little bit.
Okay. So you don't, would you want to actually do damage to her?
I mean, she's being a little bee face, isn't she?
Well, I'm just saying, do you want to intimidate her or do you want to attack her?
Well, I guess, technically I'm attacking her because I'm stabbing her hand, but I'm not doing it to hurt her. I just want her to be like, we can hurt you.
Okay.
So just FYI.
Through her hand or next to her hand?
Terrifying. Terrifying.
Through it. So it's going to hurt her, but it won't like.
You're just sending a message and it happens to include some blood.
Why don't you just spank her?
It's like, but you don't want to hit any like important tendons. You want to just
She's not gonna, clean. It's not gonna suffer like lifetime damage.
Okay.
You know.
But.
Okay. So no, you're gonna stab precise. Her with your dagger. So just make a regular roll to hit.
20.
That hits.
She is gangster.
Oh, yeah.
Are you just making this up, Okuda?
I think I took your luck this week.
I know you did. Yeah. There you go.
So roll damage now.
Which is how many sides again?
You are Tink, so you're doing your dagger. It's actually just 1d4 plus 4.
1d4 plus 4. So 3 plus 4 is 7.
Awesome.
That was a lot of damage there.
That's a message.
That's a tendon. She's never going to be able to flip anybody off again. Okay, but that's cool.
But that's probably good for her.
It's probably good for her. Yeah, it's good for her soul.
I do it with a smile. Like, I don't want her to, like, you know.
That's so much worse.
Do you say anything?
Yeah. I just going to be like, hey, just FYI, we don't want to hurt you, but we also don't want you to make us hurt you. So,
right.
Awesome. And like, you know, did this hurt? Because if this hurt, then we could hurt you a lot more. So I feel like, you know, I just want to, you know, baby steps, you know what I mean?
Quite a monologue.
Yeah. Okay.
I couldn't have said it better. That was great.
That was great.
It's a Wonder Woman show, really.
That's really good.
Amy, I'm meeting with a plumber later. I'm just wondering if you could just like come for negotiations. just please be on the call.
So actually, Amy, roll with advantage. Roll an intimidation check. With advantage is 2d20s and you take the higher of the two.
Oh, great. Okay. So 16.
Okay. So you get she her eyes widen and she goes, "Oh, wow. I really hate confrontation." She doesn't quite get words out, but she looks absolutely terrified. Zabu, it's your turn.
Okay. Jeez Louise. All right. She's already intimidated. I'm gonna pull out the Wand of Orcus.
oh my God.
Right now?
Just a quick little look, I got 7 charges in the thing.
No, wait, okay. Really?
You're gonna nuke all of us.
You're gonna waste our nuclear power?
No. You guys, no.
You're just gonna scare her or what?
Just gonna try to scare her. Just gonna scare her a little bit. All I wanna do.
Should we save that for the fiend, maybe? Okay, whatever.
Okay,
it's
fine,
your
fine,
turn.
Fine. I'll save it. Okay.
Samuel, do what feels right.
You have 7 of them. Go for it, man.
At least do a really long speech.
Look, I mostly want to just surround her. I'm gonna pull up my one orcus threateningly, be like, "This is the most fucking powerful thing out here," and then have my Indian zombie posse surround her as much as I can.
Okay, so the way I imagine that happening is you're very zombified too. Your skin is drooping off of your bones, and you're just kind of like waving the thing around, like, "Look at this, so you know." And it's like, and you're just doing it like this. But this is, by the way, like a super heavy mace with like an iron skull on the end of it. But you're just kind of dangling it around, like, "Looky loo, look what I have! Ha ha ha! Nee 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 nee." So she looks at that and goes, "You're in bed with the demons too?"
In bed?
No.
I mean, yes, I am. So yes, tell me everything. Tell me everything that I just already know.
Yeah, I will. I will. You're in bed with Orcus?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Orcus and I, we go way back. We went to grade school together.
What?
Yeah.
It's a euphemism.
Oh, it's my gosh.
Is it a euphemism?
Okay. Well, then... Oh gosh! Then
start then talking. Start releasing.
Okay, then it can't be you. It can't be you. And she looks at Clara and.
Oh great!
Clara, make a wisdom saving throw.
Oh Jesus!
Oh boy!
Okay, that's it.
Wow, the face.
She's gonna choose which one of us. That's it.
That's
not gonna be me though. So. No, but I care about
it. We're all in bed with Orcus.
Yeah, we go in the back door.
Oh, sorry, Clara.
That was, I'm sorry, that was 18.
18. Okay, so you feel ethereal tendrils, like hands or tentacles, surround you like rope, and you immediately just bring your arms to your side. It feels almost like a straitjacket. And as they clinch tighter and tighter, they just kind of dissipate, and you're left just feeling like something tried to grab you but disappeared past you.
Now, would I? Wow. Can we see that?
You can't see that. No.
So that, I would not have perceived that.
You could, what you could have perceived
is,
yeah, you could perceive her screaming, you could perceive her going, whoa, whoa, whoa. And
so reasonably, could I have maybe thought that was an attack of some kind?
Yeah.
Because that was, okay, great, so I stab.
You're right. Really, like, kill this woman.
Okay, all right, roll.
I made my choice.
Yes, roll to hit.
Great. Oh, no. Well, my heart's not in it, so I rolled an 11.
Okay, how dare you release my friend? Ah, shit. perfect. Now that, oh, Clara, you actually got to go before Thrashen. I'm so sorry, but go now.
Oh, well, let me just try to take a breath here and. Listen, I wasn't going to be aggressive, but I just got attacked. So, I mean, I guess I, you know, I'll pull out my dagger too. Jeez.
What's in her hand? Do we see what's in her hand?
Yeah.
You saw that it was, give me one second, like a something that looked like a nail, and it disappeared when she cast the spell.
Oh. Why are you being so lame?
Clara, you would know that she was like, she didn't, she had to use spell components to cast her spell. And the iron, she was trying to cast a spell using the little piece of iron.
Oh, I see. Oh,
cut her hands off. That's
Listen,
it.
Oh, you already got stabbed in the hand. Shall I stab the other hand? I mean,
yeah, you can stab the other hand.
This? Why are we doing this to her?
Because she just
attacked to possess Clara's soul.
I know, yeah. but
and that wasn't very nice. I was not doing anything.
You know what? I'm so sorry. Like, I'm sorry. I'm just as sorry as you, but you know I can't defy a demon lord.
I know, that's what I'm saying. I don't think it's her fault.
Have to, like, attack me personally.
Well, not you. Oh. If not you, definitely not whoever this zombie, they're not going to want his soul. His soul looks tainted.
All of our souls are really not in great shape.
Yeah.
So
I don't, well, it's either you or it's you thief. Because
no, you don't want my soul. No,
it's definitely just not going to be anybody else. That's what I told them. I told them I would deliver a soul every year. So it's either, I mean, you guys have to decide. It's not.
I'm
like
not
you
a great person. I'm
demons.
Cursed by a werebear. It's, you don't want this.
There's an old person down the lane. They looked very nice. They were selling some crochet and macrame. They look ready.
They look.
That is that's a pristine
that's
spirit.
That's a bar.
Yeah.
That's
we're
our bar.
Days away from any dying.
No,
anyway.
I'm the mayor of this town. I have to protect its residents.
We're not residents.
What do you
no,
think we
you're
are?
Not.
Yes, we are.
You're like, yeah, you were recruited. You were recruited to pay the soul tax.
Oh,
I hate to
a,
say it.
It was a bit from the start.
But if not y'all, then my people.
Yeah, I'm.
Oh my God! Can we just
stab your other hand?
Is there another way we can get you out of this? But besides,
can we find
soul?
You some other guy to just like?
Or can we stop the soul tax situation? Fox.
Let's give him fox.
It's soul tax day. It's soul collecting day. You can't stop it in a day.
Apply for an extension.
Sure. We're in a pandemic.
Maybe a payment plan, like just
apply for an extension.
September 15th.
Wait, what kind of?
It's not my. It's not my deal. It's not my deal to change it. If you want to change it, you would have to talk to Dork.
Okay, who's
Dork?
To who?
Dork?
Dork. Dork is the soul collector. He's a
Dork.
Dork.
He's
Dork.
Yes.
Where is
Dork?
What does he look like? Is he a
Dork,
is he a giant?
Dork with a D.
Dork. Okay. D-O-R-N apostrophe K.
Dork.
With apostrophe.
Wow, fancy.
I hate people right. Punctuation.
Fancy or just so. Evil. The apostrophes are fancy or evil.
Well, we just find Dork.
Dork.
Give us the, he should wait, be here any second. You won't have long to wait.
Hey, so what's the history on this? Why did you guys come up with this terrible scheme?
Well, I didn't do it. This is like how Bumble Hollow has survived for years and years and years. It just, I did implement, when I became Mayor Shaman, I was sick of seeing all of my family and friends perish. So I got smart and I started doing what I did with you guys. Yes. Am I a bad person or am I a brilliant person for saving my people? But I put out tiny little asks of for like, you know, young aspiring people who might be a guild or adventurers to do a certain task and then reward them with a house. And then they become residents, which is part of the deal that the resident, a resident of Bumble Hollow has to be the soul collector. That's what protects our town. So yeah, you guys answered my little thing and somehow succeeded and then succeeded again. So maybe you are stronger than I thought, but you don't get out of this.
How many adventurers have you sacrificed to dead devils at this point?
One a year.
Oh, and just a quick follow-up on that. Why shouldn't we slit your throat right now? Is there just is there a reason? You have like a good idea? Nothing?
I will say the demon lord does want me alive. And I do help protect.
Yeah.
I do help protect the portal.
The portal. The portal in what's his face's house? Jasper's house?
The door. Yeah, I protect the door. So
but if we just like kill you before he gets here,
You kill me, yeah, you could kill me, and I am not exaggerating when I say all hell will be unleashed on the material plane.
Okay, you're not that important.
No, I mean,
sorry, Sebastian.
I'm
also brittle at the ends. Okay, so you need to maybe step off. Okay.
Do you know what the chalk circle is? At Jasper's house?
Well, it's soul collection day. So I imagine, I mean, Jasper is in on it. It's not like he doesn't know what's going on. I think he's the one who invites the demon. The demon has to be invited somehow to come to Bumble Hollow. So I think that was the invitation.
It's like an
fun invite, if you want to think of it that way.
Okay, yeah, guys, we should
theme.
We should not kill her because if one of us has to go to hell, then that's not
okay,
a good thing
listen,
to do.
Let's not kill her. Let's not kill her. Let's knock her the fuck out, and then I'm gonna impersonate her with my.
Barb. Wait, then we'll give them Barb.
Vork, what did you want to do on your turn?
I was gonna knock her unconscious.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, okay, great.
Thank you. Perfect.
Let's all take a turn. Okay. Let's do it.
Okay.
I guess I can headbutt her maybe or something. I don't want to hurt her.
Use
your sword, man.
My sword, just like the tip of the sword, like the handle.
Yeah, pommel.
Not the tip of the sword.
The other tip.
Just the bottom tip.
Just the tip.
No, can I just, whatever knocks her unconscious, the least dangerous way, the least injurious.
Shit. You know what? Sorry, Vork. I didn't write your name down, so you were never part of this. What number did you get?
Oh, I was 7, I think.
Oh, okay.
No, he was 7. Yeah.
He was almost last.
You wrote it down.
Oh, I did. Okay. Great. Okay. So, great. So you want to knock her unconscious.
That's going to maybe kill her.
It's going to require a pretty hefty blow, but I guess say she's distracted. She's talking to everybody. So you can roll with advantage.
So she it's 24.
Her arm. It was 24?
No. Oh. Yes, it was 24.
24.
So this is an unarmed strike, right?
It's up to you. It can be armed if you're using it with your weapon. If you're
Use the pommel of your sword.
Yeah, the pommel would
still. Okay, so I can use I'll use my great sword to hit her over the head.
Yes. Okay.
Roll with advantage to hit.
Just bonk.
Wait, this is 20, right?
Yeah. Roll 20.
Roll 20 sides at twice.
Well, you can click the actual hit on the 18. Item.
It was 18. Okay. Is it 18 plus 6?
Should be.
That's a 24.
Holy shit, a 24.
Oh my god, the prophecy is true.
What?
You can roll again.
Okay,
so this roll is again, foretold.
Roll again to see if you beat it.
oh yeah, with advantage, sure.
Maybe it'll just kill her.
Roll so again if you see again? If you beat it.
If you crit, you might, well, crush your skull.
Yeah.
Do so it, do again. It, do it.
Yeah, just okay. Roll the 20 again. Just do it. Just do it.
This time it was just 14.
Okay. 14. All right, 14 won't hit, but the 24 definitely hits. Just roll damage for me. She does have a shit ton of hit points, but roll damage anyway.
And that's all. Oh, that's two six-sided dice, right?
Yeah. Yes, plus four.
Two. I'm putting in two. That comes up seven. What's seven times two? 14, 18. Is that right?
No.
What? Wait, how could you have 18?
Yeah, it's two.
I thought it was, it's two six-sided die. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm multiplying.
Okay.
It's just 11.
11, okay. That's no,
some Robin math. No problem.
Okay.
Okay. Oh. One of those Thorson die.
Okay, so I guess she's still distracted, and I'll let you do it again, Vork. That doesn't quite bring her down, but she's like, she just goes, okay, you don't, I'm telling you, you don't want to do this, but if it has to be done, yeah, just knock me out. And I mean, you can't kill me anyway. They'll bring me back, but yeah, make it look like you did it. Go ahead. And so she offers you to knock her out. And so
that's awfully sporting.
Yeah. So she allows you, Vork, to attack her one more time. And this time it does knock her out. And she's on the ground. At this point, you guys could, you know, kill her. But as you know, she would have saving throws or death saving throws. And she did say the demon would bring her back.
That's fine. Yeah.
But yeah, it's now she's knocked out.
Zabu, do you want to do your
thing? We're going to roll her in a carpet. We'll roll her into carpet, and then I guess Zabu's going to take her place.
Well, there's cabinets here. I want to just pick her up and kind of like stuff her into a cupboard.
Well, okay. Actually, you know what? What I realize now after reading this more carefully is let's just like puppet her body, and then I can use, because I can't really actually take the form of her, turns out, with my spell.
You've been doing that for like
would have been great to know a second ago.
I've been cheating for a while. But I think we can weaken a Bernie's her, and then I can do her voice as a minor illusion.
Great, perfect, yes.
Is anybody going to believe that?
I'm going to take one arm.
Yeah, wait. You guys are going to nail it.
Who wants to grab the other side? Come on, help me out here.
Guys, hold on.
Zabu. Yeah. Which spell are you looking at?
Oh, because, well, both of them. So disguise self, I can make myself look a little different, but I don't think I can look totally like somebody else. It says you can't change your body type, so you must adopt a form that has the same basic arrangement of limbs. Otherwise,
it just means a humanoid. So like you can't necessarily like you failed the fungal. You know, you can't look like a mushroom because you've got some extra shit going on.
Okay, so I can do it. I can look like her.
Totally. You can. This is very funny, however.
Yeah. All right. No, don't be sorry. But if you want a puppet her, that's fine too. I just want to let you know that.
I don't think
that
she's a please don't. Please don't.
All right, god damn it.
Okay, sorry.
She also has a hole in her hand. Okay. So you're
I'm gonna put her back in the cabinet.
Yes. I look like her.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm ready to do this.
Okay. And I guess you just kind of
you guys hide.
Yeah. Kind of you hide, but Jasper, like you hear the Jasper and the fiend making their way towards the hut. If you
wait, get behind some curtains.
If you were listening, you could hear them kind of stop off at each of your houses. And then, Jasper is like, oh, we must be at the mayor's. They were right here. And
before they come in, I'm going to cast protection from good and evil. Evil and good on Zabu, and I'm going to do it against a fiend. And that means they have creatures of any type have disadvantages on attack rolls against the target. The target also can't be charmed, frightened, or possessed by them.
Wow.
That's okay. Amazing.
So I'm going to do that on Zabu just to be careful.
Okay. Damn. Amazing. So he's at least a little bit protected. As you hear them approach, Jasper goes, you want to do the honors? And Dork opens, just like opens the flap of the tent and goes, hello, I'm here to collect a soul. You. A yeeny, meeny, miny, mo. Well, I didn't establish who was who. Hold on. Okay. So we'll say Clara's 1 to 2.
Wait, who was he looking at? Because we're all hiding, aren't we?
Oh, you are? Are you hiding?
Yeah.
Are we all hiding?
Oh, I didn't know.
I don't think there's enough room to hide.
I got behind something.
You did?
Hold on.
Yeah.
Something.
Oh, okay. All right. I didn't know. Sorry. Okay, everyone. Yeah. I guess you have plenty of time to find a decent hiding spot.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, because I want you to talk to Dork and talk him out of.
Yeah, because we're hoping that Zabu can kind of resolve this while we are like low key.
Got it. Sorry about that. So he opens the door and says, I'm here to collect souls. And then he stops talking.
Dorky's so good to see you. Oh my God. Is that a new skull earring? Like a gauge?
It's a new gauge.
It's a block.
Makes my ear look twice as big.
It's very sexy. So hey, look, just out of curiosity, what if we like didn't do the soul thing this year and then like 2 next year? Can we maybe like lay away the the soul thing? Like, what if we just decided that we weren't gonna do it this year?
Maybe just offer him someone else?
Yeah, I'm gonna get to that. I just wanna see what happens.
Yeah, okay. Ha ha.
Oh, no.
You try this every year.
Ugh, yeah, I sure do.
Yeah, well, okay. Knock-knacks. Knock-knacks is a greedy master. So I guess the long and short of it is no.
Okay, knock-knacks. Fair. That's a word.
Knock-knacks.
Let me ask you this now. So Barb, we're thinking Barb will be a good one for you this year.
Yes,
her crocheting has lost a stitch or two.
That's not.
So
that isn't what you told Knock-knacks.
I know, but
I mean, I've got a contract.
A soul's a soul, isn't it?
Yeah, but some of them are better than others, and she's on her way out. He would have never agreed to that. He wants lively souls that are going to build him the best currency. You know what I mean?
There's a guy named Fox. He's very lively. Quotes a lot of stupid, lively quotes.
Yeah, are you listening your friends now? Because I'm really looking. I've got a contract for 1 Blades, Clara, or Zabu.
Right. Okay.
It's gotta be Clara.
What is
so
Blades, just go.
Can we just nominate Blades?
Can we just table that vote right now? Can we push Blades out? Y'all can telepathically communicate.
Yeah,
it's in our heads, but
anyone have any ideas? Is there any way to break the contract or fulfill the contract in any other way besides
Thrashen? This has been really fun.
Can we give them everyone else in the town but us?
Kill them.
What if we give you everybody else in the town? All, like, literally the rest of the residents of the town. We empty this place out. Ghost town.
Zabu.
It's like an upfront. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. You get the sense that even with his drab, kind of droopy, stoic face, there's a twinkle in his eye.
Oh, no.
And
he likes you.
And
give him the off the playoff.
He basically sneak attacks you.
oh my gosh.
And grapples you and shoves his big meaty hand down your throat. And you all see this happen.
It's not cool.
And
not
he
cool.
pulls out what looks like a dirty rag. And
what did he swallow that rag?
What's the rag?
And he said, so this, it looks like a droopy husk of like maybe something a snake sloughed off, but it's, yeah, it's really gross. And it's more fabric-y. And it looks like it's covered in something like oil or gasoline, and it's kind of dripping, not blood, but something really dark and viscous. And he goes, well, this won't do at all, but I know you're not thrashing. Here, eat this. So you're, as soon as he pulls the thing out of yourself, you feel an immediate, you're just a general malaise and you apathy, like the worst human emotions ever, which are really apathy. Like you don't care one way or another, no rage, no anger, definitely nothing joyful or anything, just like total despair, really. But when he hands it to you back, you get some of those feelings back. And he looks at you and goes, eat it. I don't want it.
Someone's got a nasty looking soul.
Who else do we have?
I'm a zombie. Guys, he's gonna come for you or Clara. Run!
There's only one way in and out of this place.
Blades, right? Just
maybe we should have carved a back door. Why do we ever? We always should have a back door.
DM, is there a back door?
DM, is there a back door?
Is
there a bathroom window?
I'll say that it is a hut, so. You could kind of try to lift the base of it, I guess.
just lift the hut.
There's no back door, but I get the essence of what you're trying to do, and you know, like if you could maybe cut part of the cloth.
It's a yurt.
The canvas.
Oh, I see.
Okay, yeah. So.
Okay, God, there's no way out.
Get out of here, Clara.
Okay.
Rip.
Run,
Clara, run.
I'm gonna,
go slower.
So this probably needs to be in within turns, right?
Okay,
so
let's
roll one more time. That was a sneak attack because you didn't see it coming. But the rest of these,
Cause like my new thing, don't I have like reactions and stuff that I can use because I'm a warcaster now and all that crap?
Since you're a warcaster, yes. If the monster moves away from you and as an opportunity attack, you can now cast a spell instead of before where you had to.
Take Clearasil, take this baby.
No. Yeah. Where's our blackhead?
Oh, the blackhead's there, right?
So I guess, hold on real quick. Well, actually, what I'm asking is this. Do I get a reaction to the sneak attack or no?
No. And
okay.
Yeah. No. So for that just happened to you. Everyone saw it and you're able to kind of react now. When we begin this order of events and order of turns, you know, this guy has already taken his turn, so he won't get to go, if that makes sense.
Also, they had a disadvantage when they had a disadvantage on attacking Zabu.
Oh, that's true.
Fuck, you're right.
By BT Dubba.
Fucking, you're right.
I should have brought that up earlier.
No, you did. And
he didn't end up doing damage.
He didn't end up doing
that's
damage.
True. Okay.
You got
it's
some
the principle of the thing.
That was my bad, but oh well.
It was more theatrical
okay, that's fine.
Than it was.
But you have advantage on any attack rolls, or you can't be frightened, possessed, or charmed by them.
Cool.
And the creatures have a disadvantage on attack rolls against you. And
that's totally fine.
Okay.
Right before all hell's about to break loose, would this be a good time to take a short break?
I'm sorry. Is a good idea. Let's take a break.
Pee-pee awesome. Time. Oh, by Pee-pee. The way, guys, we are going to be giving away a Dragon Burns design box. Dragon Burns Designs is an awesome place. They made us all these boxes, and we're going to be giving one away. They're going to directly send it, so we can't sign it. It's also only for people in the U.S. But thank you so much. Check out their website, Dragon Burns Design. They're beautiful. You open them up, they're gorgeous. Blah blah blah. And we will be back in a minute.
Yeah. Okay. So we're back. Hi. Thanks for bearing with us. And the the fiend just reached in, grabs Zabu's wet rag of a soul, tossed it back to him. And at this point, we're entering initiative. So it'll be Zabu, Clara, Thrashen, and then Jasper. So Zabu, you're up.
Okay.
We're continuing the order from last time. Just
great.
Oh, I see. Okay.
All right. So, sorry, my wife was just texting me and it distracted me.
Yeah, what's she say? Here?
Yeah, what's going on?
She says she needs the baby monitor from me. Can I go give it to her real quick?
We can't stop you. Anyway, Zabu's going to eat his soul and put it back in his body. Clara.
Yeah, exactly. There's
just kind of a lot. Yeah.
Probably should do that.
He probably should do that. Yeah. Clara, what's up?
I thought I stabbed a little hole through the yurt and ran out.
Okay. Yep.
just cut a hole in there.
I said I'm leaving. I don't want my soul to get.
I'm leaving.
Okay. Yeah. Cool. So we'll say that. Yeah, you can move about your speed 30 feet away. That's totally fine. You're running. But then it's Thrashen's turn, and she's knocked out. So it's Jasper's turn, and he's gonna chase you. He can get to you because he's not taking an action. He's just running to you, which means he can double his speed. And he kind of gets between you and the way that you would leave. That's his turn. Vork, it's your turn.
Okay. What's going on?
Okay. So Clara, it looks to you like Clara has escaped, but you do hear footsteps running outside to kind of commandeer her. And other than that, Thrashen, the mayor shaman, is knocked out. And then there's this big, hulking, 10-foot-tall, beefy, tusk-horned, spiked demon in this hut with you guys. Pretty okay. Small hut.
And who's more threatening? I guess the demon right next to us.
The demon's pretty threatening, yeah.
Well, I guess I'll try to fight the demon.
Awesome.
Okay, right.
So you and Clarisol can fight together.
Okay, and Clarisol has 60 hit points, is that right?
That is right.
Robust blackhead, wow.
Mm-hmm. Right. Remind me what it was, Clarisol. How does she fight? Or how does it
they fight? They
fight. Sorry, excuse me.
That's okay.
How do they fight?
Oh my God. This is how in it I am. I forgot to get up I have the stats, it's an actual monster, but I typed in Clarisol to search for the monster stats, and there aren't. D&D Beyond doesn't have Clarisol.
There's no Clarisol.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. I'll control Clarisol.
Okay. So, I don't know where I am.
You're in the hut. I think you were hiding, but you're not more than 15 feet away from the monster, so you could definitely attack the fiend.
So I could do a two-weapon fighting, I guess.
Totally.
Let me see.
I guess so what I that would just look like is roll twice to hit, and that would be two hand axes. So roll two d20s, and remember, since Clarisol's on your back, you can attack with advantage because Clarisol is in their natural habitat. On your back, where your big fat pores are.
God.
And so actually roll two d20s twice. So okay. Roll the first pair first.
So roll two at a time, okay.
Two d20s twice. Yeah, you're gonna be rolling four d20s, but the first pair of d20s, roll them now.
Okay, tell I got me a which 20 and a 10. I got
on
20.
The die?
Oh my God.
A 20 on the die?
A B, yeah.
Yeah.
A B!
Okay, so you crit, which means dice are nice, you roll them twice. So roll two d6s.
What is happening?
Vork is attacking the fiend.
And
no, I meant like with his rolls.
Yeah,
I know. I'm using the.
I think his rolls are an average of 21.5.
I'm using the computer generated. I got 7 together, the 2 6-sided.
Okay, he's using roll20.com.
So that's 11 then. So that's 11. And now you get to roll your other hand axe. So roll that. And that's with advantage. So roll 2d20 again. Oh, 11. Again.
Right. I see what you're saying. Mm-hmm. I should have just told you 11. That would have been a good idea. So this is two die. Okay, so that's 9. So plus, so that's 13.
Is that the higher one?
Oh, I'm sorry. It's 5 and 4. Five and six four. Sided.
Oh, you rolled a 5 and a 4.
Oh, sorry. Oh, sorry. Are you rolling the d6s?
You told me. I thought you told me d6s.
I'm sorry. I might have said that. I meant roll 2d20s again.
Right. Okay. Let me do that again.
Sorry.
I got 16 and 14.
Total or on the die?
I'm sorry. I guess I just tell you the highest one is 16.
Is that one? Sorry. Is that on the die?
Yes. Oh, I'm sorry. Wait, what am I plus? Sorry.
No, you're doing great. I'm not being clear.
I'm sorry.
How do we get worse at D&D?
Okay.
You're doing well.
Progressively worse and worse.
I should have gone over this again because it's been a while. But yeah,
it's plus 6, so 20.
20. Okay, perfect. 22. That does hit. 20 hits and nice. Whatever was higher hits. So now roll 1d6.
Below your average. Four.
It's 1d6 plus 4, right? Yeah. Okay, that's 6 plus, oh my God, it's in the corner. Hold on a second. 4, so 4 plus 8.
8, okay, awesome. So you actually take a chunk out of this guy. This guy is beefy, but your hand axes like stick him in his big fat arms on both sides, hack, hack, and you're able to pull them free, and Black Icarus blood kind of drips out of him.
Yes.
You definitely did some good work.
Yeah.
You definitely did some good work on him. And Clarisil also gets to go.
Oh yeah.
Clarisil they get a bonus. Ooh, yes. Okay, they hit. And what's weird is the way that Clarisil which if you remember, this is like a humanoid fibrous blackhead. Like when you squeeze one out and it just looks like a cylinder, like a pool noodle, but they're like 3 feet, 3.5 feet tall now. And the way that they fight is, and you guys are fighting back to back, you just spin them around and they reach out and just kind of like almost gently and really nurturingly touch the fiend. They definitely hit, but they take, let me see. Yeah, that's not magic or anything. Interesting. Okay, yeah, they just take the full damage. So everyone who's hit them before, you can tell that as much as you're like hacking into them and doing like a severe amount of damage, it does seem there's something going on where your hits aren't as effective as they were against, say, Rubu. But when Clarisil touches this guy, you can see some weird, his eyelids kind of close a little, and the fiend Dork gets a little like droopy eyed. So something went on, like he's thinking about something. Okay. Mm-hmm. That was Vork and Clarisil. So Codex, it's your turn.
Oh boy. Okay, I'm going to cast. Boy, oh boy. I feel like I need to protect. I'm going to do protection from evil and good on. No, I'm going to just bless 3 people. I'm going to bless Vork. I'm going to bless Tink. Yay. And I'm going to bless Blades.
Aww.
Oh wait, nice. You know what? I'll do a level two, and I'll just bless Zombu too. So I'll do a level 2 bless, and I'll bless 4 people.
Do you not want to do Clara? Because
she's running away. She's running away. Okay. I can't see her. So you bless up to 4 creatures because I'm gonna do a level 2.
Oh, Clara.
When you cast this, so guys, whenever you make an attack roll or saving throw before the spell ends, which would be this whole thing, the target can roll a d4 and add the number to the attack roll or the saving throw. Okay?
Copy that.
So there you go. And that would be my turn.
That's Codex's turn. Blades, it's your turn.
Okay. So I don't think, is it obvious that Clara has cut out like a Clara-sized hole in the yurt and run away? Can we all see that?
I would say, yeah. I
don't... Cut it out.
Yeah.
That's exactly her outline.
Yeah. At least for y'all two who were hiding, I imagine fairly close to each other. Yeah, Blaze, you know that that's what she did.
Okay, but I also saw what's his face? Never Muddy.
Jasper, right? Never Muddy. Yeah. He bailed from the tent and
okay.
He ran
away. Shit. All right. I'm gonna burst out from the curtains and draw my rapier.
Okay.
Oh boy.
I'm gonna message Clara. I'm just gonna say, survive. And I'm gonna bum rush the fiend and go just to tackle him down.
Awesome. Okay. So are you attempting a grapple?
I'm kind of just trying to knock him out of commission so everyone else can just kind of scatter.
Okay.
Assuming that I'm gonna lose my soul in the process.
I see.
Wow, gotcha. Very
what?
Wow. Okay. So
too bad you didn't have a better one-liner to do that. I mean, survive. Not the best writing, but you know.
And I'm like, who's survive. Talking to me? Someone's talking to me.
There's
I don't
a lot
know
going on. Survive.
Maybe do another pass on that.
Best Ryan Gosling.
Okay. I get back behind the curtain.
Survive.
I'll think it over.
Wait, you're gonna think. Wait, what?
No. I'm going.
You're going. Okay. Perfect. Okay, so yeah, you can definitely run at this guy. He's gonna be pretty easy to hit, but I am gonna say he's a large creature, so he is one size. You can still grapple him, but it's gonna be hard for you. But
I might just bounce off this guy. It's fine.
What you're attempting to do it doesn't seem to be working in your favor. This is going to be a strength check versus his either strength or dex check. And he's definitely choosing a strength check. So
ooh, I got a hot see. Minus one. Hot here I come. Here I come, dork.
Six. Oh man, this what is like the equivalent of Tinker.
Oh, actually, I got an 18.
I also got an 18.
Hey, can you use the plus four that
I can.
You can do use a 1d4 that I gave. Oh no.
That's
no,
right.
Oh,
there gosh. You go. I'm gonna drop that 1d4 right now.
With the bless, yeah.
And that's a total of 22.
Yeah, you
as I rush Dork.
Boom.
You rush Dork, and against all odds, the tiny figure of Blades' body topples this big hulking 10-foot guy. The bigger they are, the harder they fall. The Dork hits the ground behind him, kind of bursting open the front flap of the tent, and he's on his back, and he's I don't know how this happened. He's grappled by Blades, so on his turn, he's got to get free.
Just got to pin. Like, oh,
this shouldn't.
Have you been taking?
Okay,
game the people's elbow.
Tink, it's your turn.
Well, I have a long sword.
Oh, a radiant damage long sword.
And I believe the big bad guy is a fiend.
He is a fiend. Oh, shit.
Which, if it is a fiend,
we're taking this point out. We're still killing your dude.
Takes an extra d10 radiant damage, apparently.
And you get advantage on the attack because I pinned him.
Yes.
What he said. So I just want to, like, murder him.
Yeah, you're gonna, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So first you attack with advantage to hit.
Great. So that would be, hold on. Please hold. What are we, okay. 13?
Plus my
what?
You get to add the Holy Avenger bonus.
Oh, Holy Event. What is the Holy Avenger bonus?
It's right next. If you look at the in your equip in your actions, your attacks, you
two.
Can just
yeah, the
plus
two?
Plus two.
Okay. So yeah, 15.
A 15 actually won't hit.
Also, aren't you blessed?
I'm blessed.
She's blessed.
Blessed. Great.
Did you roll a d4?
No.
Roll a d4.
Oh, thank God. 3.
Yeah, then that actually does hit. An 18.
There you go.
18 hits. So
thanks, Codex.
I'm doing my job over here. Yeah.
So you do what the hell do you do? You do 1d8 is this? You're not creatures friendly to the earth, saving throws on spells.
Whoever lands a hit gets to wear the bangs.
I wish I could give you all bangs. Okay.
I want awesome. I want all of us to wear the same exact color bangs. Exactly.
Oh, okay. So are you holding, if you're holding this with both hands, then you get to roll 3d10.
All right.
So roll 3d10.
Then yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Wow. Ooh. Oh, man, wait, I gotta look at this guy because he's got
3, 8, 9, 20.
20 radiant.
20?
20 radiant damage.
Not bad.
No.
What do you mean no?
Oh, I'm just looking at this guy and because I thought he had resistance or anything, but he does not.
I think we were supposed to win this encounter.
I think so.
Yeah, no.
But I wasn't supposed to kill him?
This is supposed to be very hard.
I was prepared to die. I was totally ready.
Yeah, maybe we shouldn't have completely OP swords.
I know you do. Okay, so Tank. Oh, it's Dornk's turn, but Dornk is grappled. So Dornk just has to try to escape the grapple.
Oh, there's no getting out of this.
Wait, so did I kill anybody or what?
You don't. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I wasn't even thinking. You just wrecked him. So this guy, you know, he's got viscous blood and it's black and it's bleeding all over. And your big fat sword, which is a long sword and kind of enormous, especially for your persona. And it glistens with radiant energy. So the entire hut is lit up and the hut itself glows like a lamp.
Beautiful.
When you stab it inside of him, the light shines out from the holes in his hands. This is like some serious Beauty and the Beast or a Jesus moment.
Beauty and the Beast.
One of the two. Pick yours. Pick your religion.
This guy's from hell. But he's a little holes and light rays just shine from him. And you can see like the will to live just kind of leaves his eyes. And you actually do see like a little bit of a smile on his face, which you couldn't have ever even imagined before. So yeah, he's not dead, but his bulk just looks a little more pathetic on the ground. Like he's just kind of splayed out and taking up space. Whereas before it just seemed like he was, you wouldn't have been able to take him down.
Did I say a few words? Or
just, yeah.
I know, I'm just kidding. I don't want to.
Say whatever you want.
I have a speech ready actually.
Die, you know, it seems like we're doing one word.
One word, yeah.
Survive.
just tell me you weren't trying to hurt him.
Best when Tink negotiates. Okay, so I'm going to. Okay, so I guess Blades, we're gonna try to escape this grapple. So you get to decide if you use athletics or acrobatics. And
it's gonna be acrobatics, I'll tell you right now.
Okay, and I'll do my strength. Which is pretty good, but let's see how good it is.
Now I get to, do I get to roll the blessed die for this as well?
No, I think you only get to use the blessed die once.
It's for attacks and saving throws.
For how long though?
It goes on for a while.
Oh, it goes for a while. It's up to 1 minute.
Oh.
Now if the original grapple is a special attack action, would this also count for the blessed die?
I'm gonna say yeah. I always interpret that as any d20 roll. So this is a d20 roll. You can add the blessed die.
23.
I got a 21.
he's fighting it. Oh, he's alive one. He's a live one.
Okay. Yeah. So he doesn't. But you do hear him speak in a language. Unless you know Infernal, you can't understand it, but he's speaking. He starts speaking
I know Infernal.
I have comprehend language.
Oh, I don't. I don't have Infernal. I have more because I took a language feat. But
I have a new spell as Zombu.
Okay. Oh, that's right. Languages. You can. So comprehend languages, you would have to use your action to cast that. which you can totally do. But he's kind of muttering, and anyone who's listening, it could be anything, but it sounds like almost like he's like whispering to himself, basically.
He's calling recruitments. He's calling
reinforcement. Or he's crazy.
Your turn, I guess. Like, he's just trying to get rid of your grapple, and on his turn, you succeeded in grappling him. So I guess part of that
they're all for sleeper hold.
I guess part of that could be, yeah, covering his mouth if you want. You won the grapple. So yeah, he's whispering, and you are like, no. And you cover his mouth, and he's not whispering.
Only just trying to just trying to mess up his words, just like
grab my fingers in there.
You did a baby.
Okay, now it's
give him a wet willy.
Now it's
Three Stooges shit.
Now it's Jasper's turn, and Jasper, Jasper's outside with Clara. Jasper,
come on, Clara. No, I'm trying.
Ooh. Jasper's not even gonna play. Jasper's just gonna attack.
What a thing!
Oh dang!
He knew you went through his cocktail bar.
I didn't. I ended up drinking my own wine.
Okay, 13 and 17, yeah. Clara. 13 and 17. They both will hit. Right, your armor class is 13, so is meet or beat.
Why does Jasper have two things?
That multi attack, baby.
Yeah, he's a high level. They're both really high level people, but I don't understand.
God, I thought he was general contractor. I didn't realize he's.
Yeah.
It takes a lot to build a house in 24 hours.
Has anyone noticed that he talks like me?
Okay, so he had a spear, like he's kind of this loincloth guy, and he pulls out a spear and he attacks you once, attacks you twice. You take let's see, hold on, let me roll real quick. 6 + 4 = 10, 5 + 4 = 9, 19 piercing damage, and 3 fire damage.
Whoa!
So 22 damage.
That's oh my god. Clara got smote.
How many hit points you have?
Yeah, that's me. I'm dead.
So Clara, hit points. Clara goes down. That doesn't mean her soul's gone, but she,
should we just give Clara to them then, since she's already dead?
Hey now.
No, we will not.
Okay.
She's making some good points.
Why are we all doing this?
I'm intent on sacrificing myself. Let me have this.
Okay.
Well, then why are you still grappling him? Why are we trying to kill him? You want to go?
So much better than I expected. I'm just going with it now.
Oh boy.
Gotta roll with it.
Okay.
All right. So
also, Clara, before you blinked out and the light at the end of the tunnel appeared, you saw a shift in Jasper's appearance, and it changed from this like kind of hardened, hot elf-like creature, a lot more just palely pink red skin, and deep-set dark eyes without whites of like one color dark eyes the entire way through, almost like an animal. That's before you blinked out of existence.
Great.
That is Vork and Clarisil now.
Take us home, buddy.
So should I just chop off that guy's head?
Yeah, you can totally try to chop off that guy.
Just don't get mine.
So, yeah, you can attack. You can attack with advantage. You can two-handed attack with advantage with your hand axes. So that
and you
means
can add your bless.
And you can add your bless the entire time. So
oh God, this hand axes.
Roll 2d. I know. Roll 2d20s and add 6 to the highest one.
Gotcha.
You got this, buddy.
Okay, guys. I've got the highest one, you add 60, right? So 21.
Damn.
15 and 5. Yeah, 5. Wait, hold on. I'm sorry. Wait. No, it's 12 plus 5.
17.
What? No, hold on.
Wait, you're adding 6.
Hold on, everybody. Just wait. Hold on a second. Okay, take a breath. The highest one was 18.
Just
total.
Relax. It's like
18 total hits.
We are not professional. No one expects us to be professional.
That hotel stereo going straight to your head.
Okay, yeah, do no it again.
Here. They do expect us to be able to add. I think that's
mathematics. Asking a lot.
Rolling the 20-sided die again twice.
Yeah.
Okay.
And add 6 to it.
Okay, so
to each of them.
Just to each of them.
Well, to the highest, but yes.
To the
highest one. Okay, so that's 23.
Yeah. So 18 and 23 both hit. So roll 2d6s and add +4 twice.
I'll do what I want.
Okay.
So 2d6s.
2d6s and 2d4s, right?
2d6s and then you just plus add 4.
Oh, +4, yeah. And then the 1d4 for bless.
That doesn't apply to damage, but.
Oh, damn it.
Only, well, you're only confusing him.
But really good try.
Okay, so I got a 5 and a 2.
A 5 and
so
a 2.
So it's 11.
7.
Plus 8.
Plus, okay, 11. Plus, and then plus another 4.
Another what?
So 15. You did 15. So because each hand axe does 1d6 plus.
Oh, right.
Each one of them does. So you did 15 damage.
Got
it. Which is. Wish I had a better look.
Give yourself facial hair instead of.
The bang stash.
Okay. Okay. Hold on.
Oh yeah, that's it.
I'm trying to think who you just looked like. It was someone.
This one, Wilford Brimley, R.I.P.
Oh, I know. I thought he was. In he's been dead for a little while. I thought.
Okay, he's not dead yet, but he is bleeding out. Now let's see if
it's not Wilford Brimley.
Not Wilford Brimley.
Oh my gosh, guys, that's not funny.
Wilford, okay, it is not funny.
Yeah, Clarissa. Oh my god. Okay, Clarissa does his damage again as well. Same thing. It looks like Clarissa has totally nailed it, and he just touches the guy again and is able to touch him because he's fucking grappled. So
the DM's angry, you guys.
He's able to just touch him and impart his weird fibrous musky blackheadness into this guy's brain, which is all the effects that the spores did on you. You can tell that they're having an effect on
Codex. Stop stroking your bangs.
No, it's
well.
Really
Codex. Weird. It's your turn.
Okay,
like you're Merkin or something.
I'm trying to skip.
Boy. Really?
What? Who got skipped?
Zebu hasn't gone in a while.
Zebu hasn't gone in a while. That's
oh,
true.
Oh shit!
You know, right. One more kiss. Did you like it?
Yeah. You were supposed to go way before. You were supposed to go before Clara.
It's okay. Yeah. We've all been off the wagon for a while, guys. It's
you spent one turn. You spent another turn eating your soul back in.
Okay,
the
great.
Okay.
So go ahead.
Do I get to go now?
Yeah.
Go before me.
So this guy's still alive. This fiend.
Yeah.
I think I can kill him, you guys. Should I kill him with the one of focus?
Yes.
Yeah, take me out with him too. I'm right here.
I think
here,
we
man.
Need to use the wand of Orcus. We can just kick him in the face. He's very bloody.
Okay,
I came close, didn't I?
Go do what you want. Do you want? It's your wand. You do it. You do you.
Just listen, okay? Because I could use Circle of Death, which if I kill him with that, he then comes into our control. I believe.
Wait a second.
I like it.
Wait a second.
Let me just make sure I'm moving the right one. Is that the right one? Spirit of negative energy. Each creature in the area. Oh, wait, no, maybe this.
That's where it gets all of
I'm
us.
I'm sorry. It's Finger of Death. Finger of Death.
Mm.
And a is he a humanoid or no?
Yeah.
Oh, well, then if I kill him with this spell, he rises at the start of your next turn as a zombie that is permanently under your command.
Wait, hold on. No, he is actually not a humanoid. He's a fiend.
Oh, he's a fiend. Okay.
Yeah, that's different.
That's what I thought. Okay.
Sorry.
Good. Well, then use the wand. Do what you want. You really want
to
use the wand.
Oh, no, hang on. To be clear, it still does
hold
the
on.
Damage.
So, do I have a line? Yeah, I know, I know. Hello, am I there?
Yeah, you're there.
I hear you.
So bad. So, do I have a sight on Jasper at all?
You can
see Jasper
if you move. You can if you move.
Oh my gosh! Hello.
Oh, did I?
Oh no, Zebu! Oh no!
Oh, wait, did we lose Zebu?
No, wait, here he comes. I see him.
We hear you now. We hear you now. We hear you now. We hear you now.
We hear the, you so hard.
Can you hear us?
Sandeep, can you hear us?
Sandeep,
oh,
can you hear us?
Oh, no.
Sandy, can you hear us?
I can hear
Sandy,
you now.
Sandy, can you hear us?
It's a really big soul to eat.
Are you okay?
Okay, so you can't, can you hear us? You can see, you can pick one to see. You can see either Jasper be move, or you can see Dork.
Oh no.
Oh no.
He's really scaring me. Did you have a scope?
That's his... You're back. Oh, you're back. You're back.
Your frozen face.
You can't hear anything? No? You can't hear anything.
Now I can hear you. Hello?
Oh, yeah. You can hear us.
Type your turn.
Yes. Yay, yay, yay. Okay, great. Take your turn.
Okay.
Okay, good. Great.
Okay, I think we're back.
And we're back.
And we're back. Sorry, guys. Really frustrating. Look, so I'm going to just use the finger. I'm going to go ahead and use the finger of death on this guy and do... Wait, is he on his last legs?
He doesn't look good. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't say necessarily last legs, but how much damage can you do?
An ugly amount.
Okay, the
wand. 78 plus 30.
Necrotic I guess damage. In,
78 plus 30.
In those fucking overpowered terms, then yeah, he's on his last legs.
Wow.
What spell would one shot some of us combined?
This is a seventh level necromancy spell, which you wouldn't be able to cast unless you were like 13th level or something like that.
Oh boy, yeah. She's very upset. Poor Amy.
Should I not do it? Is that
do what you want?
Fucking do it. You have to. You have to. This guy's gonna take your soul.
Well,
you do it. You're in character. You have to kill this guy. He's. I'm only fake mad.
Do what you need to do. Do your character.
Do what you need to do. Yeah. You can't base your life around what I want.
No, you can't.
Okay, so I send, can you hear me? I hope you can hear me.
Yes.
Send negative energy coursing through a creature that you see within range, causing it searing pain. The target must make a constitution saving throw. It takes 78 plus 30 necrotic damage on a failed save.
Okay, constitution saving throw. That's great.
Or half on a successful save.
Or half on a successful save. That's right.
Okay, constitution is pretty good. I have plus 9.
Ooh.
And... is this a spell? Yeah, this is a spell. So I have advantage on it. So let's see. Oh, that is 17 plus 9. So 26. Your...
That might be above his spell save.
The saving throw would be 18.
Yeah. Okay, so he saved, but then he still takes damage?
He still takes half damage.
So wait, the hit DC is 18. Is that...
I got a 26. He has a plus 9 con.
Okay. Okay. All right.
So still roll 78 plus 30.
Plus 30. Here we go. 78 plus 30.
And then he takes half?
Yeah.
Wow.
That is...
it's a gross amount of damage.
68. So 34 damage.
Okay. Go ahead and describe how this guy dies.
Okay, so
wow,
Zabu leaps over, takes the wand of Orcus, sticking it in the nearest hole or orifice he can find. Actually, Blades does a nice job of opening his mouth for me. I jam the wand of Orcus in there,
get him there,
and take a stance, and I go, survive this. Kind of a one-off.
Oh, good one.
You made it work. One.
And yeah, I tried to make
only because of Zabu. Yeah. Only because of Zabu.
God damn it.
And I blast the finger of death into his mouth hole.
Oh, God.
Okay.
So
when you do, everyone within 30 feet, so that's everyone, including Jasper, actually.
Not Kara, though, right?
They ran, right? Were they running?
Yeah, but she could only... she could only move 30 feet. But yeah, I could say, yeah, maybe not Clara. Let's say not Clara.
I mean, she's dead anyway. So
I mean, it's fine. We don't care.
That's fine. You're right. She's dead. So.
You
guys. She's hopeless.
I'm right here. Oh my
God. You can't hear
it's her. Almost like I can still hear her voice.
Yeah, she's gone.
You can't hear us.
But Jasper, No, then Jasper wouldn't have to be there. So, well, I guess even fucking Thrashen would have to. Everyone make a DC 7 dexterity saving throw.
Oh, that should be easy.
Oh, sorry, 17.
Oh, that should be hard. Uh-oh. Remember, if you're blessed, add your bless to it.
Oh, that's true.
Wait, what's happening?
Make a dexterity saving throw. So on your character sheet, those will be in the top left-hand corner.
God damn it.
I see it.
They're a little bit different than the abilities at the top.
Oh, no.
Okay.
And then I roll another d4?
Yep, to add to it. And then...
Wait, everybody does that?
Everybody, yeah. Vork, you too.
I rolled a one.
Oh.
I did not roll a one. I did not save.
Wait, and then
save.
You roll a four, is that what you said?
A D4, yeah. Well, not you.
Claire can't.
No, well, let me just roll, guys.
No, you can't roll. You ran. Yeah.
Dead people don't roll.
17.
Oh, God.
Hey, Robin.
What?
Clarisil got rolled a one, too, and he's got a negative four dex.
Oh, God, we're going to die together, me and the blackhead.
So,
I don't think most of us saved.
Jasper did not save.
I had 14.
No, Jasper didn't have to roll.
Did any of us save?
I got a 17. So. Isn't that really good?
I got a 14.
So yeah, you're looking for a 17 or more. And then
you're only Tink saved.
Tink saved.
Tink is the only one who got a 17 or higher, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Thanks. Okay, so Thanks here's what us. Happens.
I mean, gummy bears, so I'm happy.
And yeah,
that's nice. And gummy bears.
Okay. Anyone who did not save takes 18 damage, 9 of which is fire damage, 9 of which is thunder damage. If you did save Tink, you just take 9 damage.
Yeah.
Yeah, you still take half damage. So
did you say 18?
18.
Yeah, 18 total damage if you did not save.
Do we have to mark down the types of damage that we took, the fire?
No, it only matters if you have resistances or immunities. And I don't think any of you have resistances.
What about if you rolled a one?
That's double damage.
So true. I think you're just dead, Codex. I think you're dead. Because your hit points are 8. Yeah, you're just 27. At 27. So even if it did one more 9 damage to you, it would take you out. What happened was, yes, Zabu, the finger of death, it did all the damage, like went into his mouth and his skull and all that stuff. It radiated and he blew up. But that's the thing is he blew up. So he's this demon that can cause himself to explode if he feels like he's about to die. And he did. He exploded. Weird black flesh, acid. A big loud sound and fire. Elemental damage just radiated from him. Everything within 30 feet of him totally explodes. I think Thrashen is pretty dead as well.
Is Clarisil dead? Are we like? Can yeah, Clarisil. Knock it up?
Clarisil's down for the count as well, but. What does happen is it seems like the remnants of this demon kind of just disappear. So it's like they melt into the ground and then it just, I don't know, disappears into the ground. It looks like it just kind of sinks in. If you try to look for him, he's just no longer there. You've got a bunch of people. Now, I will say for both Clarisil, Clara, and Codex, they're at the point of making death saving throws. They're not quite gone, but Thrashen is dead and can only be resurrected.
I mean, fine.
We're okay with
you
that.
You win some, you lose some.
That's fine. Yeah. Okay, so.
Oh, wait, we still have to deal with Jasper, right?
Do we know Jasper's, what's going
yeah,
on?
Yeah, you're right. Jasper's still alive.
But also, what's he doing with Clara?
She did say she died.
Jasper, now, I guess we're still in initiative technically. So let's see what happens. So just so you know, other D&D players, you're going to want to stabilize your crew. to prevent them from making death saving throws. If you remember last time, Blades succeed. You get
remember that.
Yeah, Blades was rolling death saving throws, and if you get three failures, you die, and you can only make one saving. You can only make one roll per turn, which is 6 seconds.
And so if you get one
on your turn, it would help you to.
Maybe stabilize me and Clearasil, and maybe figure out. Do we know what happened to Clara? We might not even know what happened.
You might not.
She's out of sight.
Zabu, you went right before Codex. Codex is down. Blades, are you still alive?
Oh yeah, totally. I'm great.
It's your turn.
Awesome. So I'm gonna take, well, because this explosion happened effectively on top of me. So I'm gonna stagger up, and immediately I'm assuming I can see the near corpses of Codex and Clearasil, right?
Yes.
Okay. First things first, I don't know where Jasper is. I'm just gonna go and try to stabilize Codex.
Perfect. Thank you, Blades.
Great. So yes, Codex, you're at 0 hit points, but you're not losing blood and you're not dying out.
Am I conscious?
Can I take a turn or?
No, you're not conscious. Somebody would have to actually give you some hit points, which would require healing.
A healing, but they could use a healing skill check to heal me or not?
There's no real healing skill check.
And that's a feat. Okay, got you. Yeah.
Yeah, y'all have you have a lot of overpowered stuff, but I don't know that anyone can heal you.
Yeah, great.
Is there like a potion or something? Or are we all tapped out for healing?
I don't think we had any potions.
This is a flaw in our party build here.
Yeah.
No, we need someone to take like a learning annex class and
Tink, it's your turn.
I have a rubber chicken.
Alive right now.
Aren't you?
No, who's alive right now?
Who's alive? Tink, Blades, and Vork.
I'm alive.
And Zabu.
I think it's just Codex.
Clearasil's dead.
Who else? That's it? I mean...
Clara, Clearasil, Codex. Oh, it sucks to have a C name. And... and Thrashen, who you probably don't care about. Thrashen's so beyond health.
Dead. Okay.
Okay. So there's nobody to kill anymore.
Well, there's Jasper outside.
Jasper.
But we don't know what happened there. We can't. We didn't hear what happened to Clara.
Can I go like outside and see where Jasper is?
Yeah, totally. I wish Zabu, Sandeep, I need to tell you something. So I'm gonna text you.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh. That doesn't sound good. So, wait, Zabu, did you lose enough hit points that you went to 0?
No. Okay. I'm at 13 still.
Okay.
What's that?
Yeah, at 31. Zombies.
Do I have the most hit points of anybody?
So not one person has any, not even a healing potion? You guys, come on.
No, we have nothing. No. I thought about this last time. I was like, none of us can heal. If Codex goes down, we're kind of
Well, that kind of makes sense for us.
I wouldn't like Codex.
It fits.
It's probably best.
I could have like a potion or something, though.
I mean, I can raise you from the dead, I think.
Yes.
I mean, someone accidentally stabilized me, so maybe we should have done that, and then I would have had to...
I can fix that.
Okay. All right, Tink, you're up.
Yeah, I went to go look for Jasper.
Yeah, great. He's right outside. He has just slain Clara, and he's standing there with two spears at the moment.
I mean, can I longbow him, or is my turn over?
Get it.
Oh no!
Oh my god! Was that a bee?
Oh,
oh
god,
she bee!
Oh my god!
Oh, dropping those hot bees.
Oh my gosh. What is happening? Wow. Okay. So on a hit, remember you can do something with your bow. You can hail of thorns it.
Yeah. Let's do that.
Okay, cool. So that makes, they have to make a dexterity saving throw. So here you go. So with your longbow, roll 2d8s and add 4 to it. Just 1 4.
Wait, roll a 4 dice or just add the number 4?
Roll 2d8 dice.
Oh, okay. Eleven.
Add 4. That's 15. Now add roll a d10. Ugh, and then I have to make a dexterity saving throw.
8.
Oof. So that, wait, I said 15, right? 15 plus 8 is 23. So my dexterity saving throw is an 11, which is not enough. So I take the full amount of that damage. So I take 23 damage for Jasper, who has not taken damage yet.
Okay.
But that's still quite a bit. As
but even know. With the hail of thorns, it's 23.
Yeah. Okay. So you crit and were able to hail of thorns him. And that actually, I know it doesn't seem like a lot of damage when you've got the Wand of Orcus on your side. 23 is a significant amount of damage.
Fine.
Yeah, so it looks, I mean, you took about a quarter of his life away. Now,
it's a very strong guy.
I'm texting. This is so weird. Yeah, but things are happening to Zabu right now.
What?
You can see this. You can see this happening. He's a zombie, mm-hmm. So his eyes are dead and everything's kind of glazed over. But before, when he was just waving around this Wand of Orcus, as soon as he focused it to kill, he's been kind of enwrapped in this.
Oh no.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
Gotta kill Zombu.
Tink. That was Tink's turn. Dork is dead and gone. Zabu, it's your turn.
Oh man, you know, you want me to, I'm sorry, you're proud of me?
Oh,
guys, the wand is telling me it's so proud of me.
Oh,
the
no.
Wand, what?
Fight it, buddy.
Orcus, oh, no, you're the man. No, you're the fiend. You're better. No.
Oh, boy.
Okay. Well, if you insist. Oh, you're such a... No, I felt it too. So just everywhere? You want me to just everywhere?
Oh, okay. Please no.
Well, let's see. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
I'm going to hide behind Codex's corpse.
Death. I'm thinking circle of death. What do you think about that, Orcus?
Oh, no.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Circle of death. The drink
at me. At that, but they're my friends. But I'm friends.
Can we like slap him or something?
Like Zabu?
It's his turn.
Oh no, it froze. He froze.
Now he froze.
Okay. The wand is taking over his internet connection.
Okay, I want a circle of death, everybody.
God.
Love you guys.
No.
What? Oh my god, I'm gonna die. I'm really gonna die. What happened?
I do this lovingly. So a sphere of negative energy ripples out in a 60-foot radius sphere from the point within range. Each creature in that area must take a constitution saving throw. A target takes 8d6 necrotic damage on a failed save or half as much on a standard successful one. My friends, you're going to love this. Orcus wants to meet us.
Oh my god. So, are we wiping? Is this it?
I got a 21 on my save.
Oh,
wait, what are we doing?
Constitution saving throw.
Oh my god. Okay.
You can use the bless dice.
I don't think we can because Codex is out, isn't she?
Oh, that's right. You're right.
Wait, why would you say that?
I mean, it's nice. I mean, blessed.
We've done some good things and some bad things tonight.
So it's a con save of 18. And then Zabu, you're going to have to roll 8d6s. I'm going to roll for Jasper.
Okay.
Wait, so what are we rolling? A d20?
A d20 and add your saving throw for 18, constitution.
18.
Ugh.
11. Ooh. Oh
my god, I'm crazy tonight, you guys.
Oh,
what'd you get?
So 20.
And ooh. Jasper got 19. So who got an 18 or higher? Everybody?
No. I definitely didn't.
Wow.
It was just 4.
Clara.
Yeah.
Oh, Claire's also in range. Yes.
I got.
Oh my gosh, she wasn't stabilized either.
No.
No.
So, okay,
so Zabu, Zombu, roll your dice.
Dead.
How much necrotic damage?
So for those who did not save, 26 damage.
Oh no.
For those who did save, 13 damage.
That's exactly my HP. God damn.
You're going to love it, Blades. It's going to be fun.
I go to negative?
I know, I'm like
negative. No, you don't go to negative. You only go to, it only matters if you go to a negative that is equal to your max hit points. So
that's Clara. Oh no. Well, she 26? Was already at zero.
You said 26?
I was at zero, yeah.
26 damage, yeah.
So I'm at negative 26? That's sad.
No, you take death failures. Sad.
Yeah.
Oh, so you have one more failure. You have one more failure.
One more failure.
Okay, mine
just says failure, success, death
saves. How many damage do you take if you did save?
13.
13.
Oh my
She's
God.
Fine. Tink
okay,
is
so
fine.
Who is alive?
Tink is all that's left.
Jasper's alive. And Tink?
And Zabu. Because he didn't take damage.
Yeah, should we kill him?
Yeah, remember that time you wanted to use that fancy-ass sword or whatever the hell?
Okay.
What's that, Orcus?
I know.
Tell them to go fuck themselves. Oh. Okay, everybody go fuck yourself.
Wait. So if I was Amy.
Yeah.
If I was already unconscious still, but I had been stabilized, right. Does that count for death saving throws for me or what?
I think I would say that's going to start the death saving throws over again on your.
So turn. I'll have one fail. I would have one fail.
No, because once you're stabilized, it goes back to like.
Oh, okay. So basically, I have to do a check next time. Okay.
Yeah, you're starting over. So that was Zabu's turn. Now we're at Clara's turn. Clara, go ahead and roll. Go ahead and roll a death saving throw. You're looking for an 11 or higher.
But I rolled a d20, right?
D20. Sorry. Yeah.
No, Clara.
Survive.
A 14.
Yep. Okay, oh so that's one survive.
God. Oh my
that's
God.
One survival. It's Jasper's turn. Jasper. Okay, Jasper's going to make a choice.
We've gotten ourselves into a pickle this time, gang.
Okay.
Amy's working overtime right now.
I think we're doing great.
Yeah, this is crazy. This is crazy. Okay, so Jasper's going to throw his... No, Jasper's going to... point his finger right at you, Tink, and a blast of fire is going to shoot out from it. He's going to do this twice. Oh, God. Does a not 9 doesn't hit, but does a 13 hit?
No, I'm 15. Armor class, right?
Vorphal wants to down you so bad.
Yeah, that's armor class. Wait, no, I had an 11. Does a 15 hit?
My armor class is 15.
Oh, okay. You're just gonna. Oh.
I got an 11. It doesn't freaking matter. Oh.
With your hair.
She's trying to take you down, Tink. She's trying to take all of us down.
No, he just misses. But make a DC 14 wisdom saving throw.
13.
Oh, okay. Oh. So you are charmed by this guy. So he misses Ooh. You and you immediately interpret it as, oh, this guy's going to save my life. I'm into him. He looks the way that he, like Jason Momoa looks and
not really into that, but
very
okay.
into it.
Are you blind?
And you're going
to
obey. You're going to obey what he says. So he misses and he goes, you guys, hey, why don't you help me retrieve this soul from your friend? And on your turn, you have to do that. Unless it hurts you. Okay. So that'll be your turn. Jasper.
Well, hang on. Because Tink is an elf, doesn't she have advantage against being charmed?
Does she?
The one guilty that knows how to play.
I know. Racial traits.
Yes, she does have advantage against being charmed.
Yes, she does. Roll one more time, Tink.
Roll what?
Roll a d20 again. You need a 14 or higher. For wisdom.
Add oh, she wisdom. Didn't get wisdom. It. Oh, wisdom. Oh.
Wisdom, you add plus three. Yeah, okay. Yeah, you add plus three.
Fuck me.
She lost. Thing. Good one, Blades.
It was a good try.
That was good.
Good try. But Amy Vorphal got angry at you.
Yeah, I saw did that. You see that sure. face?
Yeah. I'm never that coming
face
back.
Was, that face was like.
I kind of liked it. It was great.
Okay.
I'm really sad we couldn't.
I'm getting it killed off screen.
Yeah, if you can repeat the saving throw if you take harm from it, just so you know. Great. So,
okay. Oh my God, you're going to help him get Clara's soul?
Vork, it's your turn, Vork.
I'm dead, right? Or do I have a...
Wait, are you dead?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Vork is dead.
Okay, make a death saving throw. 11 or higher.
I had 26.
Roll a 20-sided dice.
Wait, what am I rolling for death? What am I doing?
A 20 D20. To get 11 or higher.
11 or higher. I can do this. Hold on, guys.
Okay.
17.
Yeah. Okay. So mark one success. Codex.
So mark one success. Okay. So what do I do? Just put a mark, but okay. In X.
Click it.
So I'm going to roll to see if I make my death saving throw. I fail it. I rolled a 3.
Okay. So you've got one failure.
Oh, no.
Great. Blades, you're up.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Hang on. Death save, baby. Oh, no. That's going to be one failure.
One failure. Okay. Tink, it's your turn.
Well, the little macho hottie, I guess, wants me to take someone's soul, right? So I have to do that?
Yeah, you do.
So, I get to pick who?
Yeah, he wasn't really clear, was he? So,
because, yeah, like, why would I make it, Clara?
Just take it.
Did Clara.
I mean, she's right in front of you.
But what if I like take Jasper's?
He would never, he said your friend and he would never ask you to take his soul.
Did you say friend though? I don't know. I don't remember what you said.
Oh, if he said friend, it's not going to be me.
He did say friend. He did say friend.
Yeah, he did.
I remember that.
None of these people are my friends. So.
Wow.
Okay.
Wow.
Do you say that to him?
Yeah, I say, I don't really have any friends here. Okay. So
I understand.
Yeah.
Give me the tiny bitches one.
The tiny bitches?
Yeah, the tiny bitches. So
who's the tiny bitch?
Oh, sorry. Her, the one in front of me. This one.
Who's in
I don't know her name.
You mean
half
that. So you're charmed by him and you really want to help him.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. No, but is he really talking about Clara? I just really don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Oh, okay. Oh, Clara.
Call him a bee. Wow. Jasper's not a good person, you guys.
The meanest Neanderthal.
It's rude.
So you want me to take her soul?
Bitches.
What are you going to give me if I do? I mean, I really want to help you, but like...
You're charmed.
You have to do it.
You got to do it.
You got no negotiated
skills. Well, I mean, I'll give you more of what we already have.
Oh, great.
Really
awesome.
Important friendship.
I promise you, none of us want this to be Clara.
Okay, well, here it is. I mean, I don't even know how to do it, but here.
Right, you don't, do you? So what do you think you do?
I mean...
Just reach on in there.
I guess
you
I just
saw what they did to me.
Don't do that.
Yeah, I stick my hand in her mouth and then I look at him and I'm like, is this, am I doing it right?
No, you're not.
Is this what
you're going to feel, go down until you feel basically like a slug thing.
Like elbow deep.
Yeah, elbow deep. You'll feel some cilia. And it'll be like a slug with sections, like a sectioned slug, and you're gonna grab it and just pull it out. It's long.
Like
it's like a foot
time.
Long.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh my God! I don't know. I don't feel it.
Oh, you don't feel it?
Well, fine.
Oh, you just okay.
Pull your spleen out.
Oh wait! I got it.
Oh, you do. Okay, pull it out.
Here you go.
Okay.
It's been a rough day, guys.
just like
you're able to pull out Clara's soul.
Her soul slug.
Is that her like a normal thing everybody can do, or did he do something to her to enable that?
You just
you're not aware of what just happened. So
we're all blissfully dead.
Yeah, you're all blissfully dead. But I guess what Tink saw, yeah, like there is a level of wow, I don't know if this is normal. But she
burst a blackhead, so
you did. You really you're a pimple popper and a soul stealer.
You're a soul snatcher.
You're oddly the right person for the job. Even though he had no idea of knowing. So So you have what you pulled out is yes, this it's white. So where Zombu's was like a wet rag husk, this is a white, voluptuous.
Oh, so pretty, Clara's soul.
Like full, it looks like it might be even full of pus or something. Like you could squeeze. It's like one of those water toys, like the water toys that.
Yes, the little snakes.
I love those. Yes. The stuff inside of it. There's no stuff inside of it.
It's a bar of soap.
Yeah, it's like a slippery bar of soap. And the on the front end of it, where you're thinking maybe there should be eyes or a horn or whatever, you kind of turn it towards you. And there's like a tiny, like shrunken and a little bit misformed in its shrunkenness, head of what could be Clara.
Oh my God.
So it has like, twin. Yeah, it has
tiny
like
pink
hair. Like Clara, it's very reminiscent, but it also the head itself looks smaller than it should be on this larva. So it's, but yeah, it's this
soul grub,
I guess, is what you're looking at. And
Clara, tough luck.
You spent your turn doing that. Jasper says, thank you. Let's see. So that's Tink's turn. Tink has harvested your soul, Clara.
Okay, great.
Zabu.
Yeah. Oh, I'm back. I know there's still some alive. I know. But look, I have already used six of the charges. I only have one charge left in the wand or key. Oh, call my friends. The horde of zombies that have 500 hit points spread out between them and have them all come over to my. And bring in my friends Chai? No, not Chai. Oh, kill them. Okay, yeah, I'll do that. Yeah, no problem. Okay. No, I'll talk to you later. No, you hang up first. You. Oh, Orky. Okay, zombie friends, Rod, Shape, they'll get over here and kill my friends.
What? Okay, so they're not there immediately, but the horde of zombies is on their way.
Two of them are there already. Are close.
Oh yeah, two of them are there already. So
a horde of Indian zombies.
Who is left?
Oh my God.
Just Tink. Just Tink. Blades, are you up? No.
I'm making death saves.
Zabu and Tink, is it? I'm making death saves. Just making death saves. We're missing him.
Jasper guy too. Just kill anybody.
I can't believe we're dying tonight, you guys.
Yeah, we're not doing well.
Okay, so two zombies, they're going to go for... So it's just Tink then, right?
Yeah, only Tink's up.
All right, let's see if they hit. These two are going to go for Tink.
I knew that one was a problem.
So 17 and 7. They just kind of wander over to you and start...
It may be time to...
What?
Nothing.
There's nothing we can do. We're unconscious, Fork.
I was just going to tell maybe time to go back to free fire. That's all. It may be time to go back to the game, dude. I think we did.
Okay, so I think one of them hits Tink. You take 4 bludgeoning damage. For now.
Will that break her out of her charm?
That is a really good question. I think
it's not just yeah.
Actually, you can make another saving throw.
Me?
Yeah. So saving throw, you're gonna want a DC 14 Wisdom saving throw again.
With advantage.
Thanks, boys.
Why advantage? So do a roll a D4.
Because you're an
D20 twice.
D20 twice. Okay.
And add your wisdom save amount.
Okay. So I had a 13 and 10. Oh, 13. So 26.
Oh, no. You just rolled two 13s. Oh, I just so you did, she didn't 13s. Make it. She didn't make it.
Well, you get to add. You get to add
13 plus 3.
13 plus 3 so is 16. Yeah, 16. So you made it. Okay. You are no longer charmed by the demon and by Jasper. And on your turn, you can act however you want. You also can't be charmed by him again. That's you also still have Clara's soul in your hand.
Treat it with kindness, please. Give it back to me.
Okay.
I thought she gave it to Jasper and he said thank you.
Oh yeah, you're right.
No, she said thank you. But did he give it to her?
I don't think there was an actual exchange.
Yeah, she goes, I don't think I played a tape on that one. I think she gave it to him.
Let's see. Yeah, I think he does have it. Because
Let's go to the replay. Say,
help me retrieve that.
I don't think he would have taken it. I don't think he would have left it in her hand. Just to be, not that I like that idea, but
you're right.
Thank
you.
Thanks.
Okay, Claire, so that was.
Amy said here, MST3K Temple.
Yeah.
Tattling. Yeah. 100%. I'm not looking at chat, but I did look at chat for that.
Yeah,
for what?
Here. I looked Amy at chat. Here. Chat agrees.
Oh, here. Oh, got it.
Handed it
Thank
over.
You. Thank you.
And I'm going to say goodbye.
A lot went wrong in this battle, and this is going to be really fun for everyone to fix.
Amy has been probably improvising since we started. Nothing has gone as planned.
Guys, if you don't hear from me until next Sunday, you'll know why. Okay, so whose turn is it? It's Clara. Clara, that was
I thought you said it was my turn.
No, she said on your turn.
Oh. Your turn. Because you took damage, you got to roll a saving throw.
Okay.
Clara, it's your turn. So you need to make another death save.
Death save.
Okay, so that's a d20.
We're looking for 14, is that right?
11 or higher. Just anything above 10.
11 or higher.
That's not, that didn't happen.
So you're dead.
No.
I think she's dead. Dead.
What no, did you, I had one. What did you success. Get? I got four.
Yeah, that's a.
How many failures are you on now?
I've only done that twice, so this is my second time.
That's your second one. Okay.
Because she did. She also. But she also took a death save from the Wand of Orcus blow, right?
Yes, yeah, so the damage should have been, I think, one automatic failure, but I might be wrong.
Yeah, so you have two failures now, Claire.
Oh, great. Thanks.
So you have to make the next one.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you guys are real.
It's a lot to take to keep track of right now.
Vince, I'm going
to
put the player's handbook away.
Stop talking. Just kidding.
I love you.
She's
studying.
Okay, yeah, sorry. I'm just looking this up. You do suffer a. You do suffer a point of, like, if you take damage while you're down, you do suffer a...
A failed, yeah, so she has a failure. But because she has a soul, why does she... Can she do a death save? She doesn't have a soul right now. Okay.
Yeah, she can. So, but you're dead now, right, Clara?
No.
She only
has one more. Okay, great.
And one success.
Okay, cool. Jasper's turn...
Did I miss a turn? Okay.
Not yet.
No.
Okay, sorry.
Go ahead. You're after Jasper. Jasper's gonna turn tail and run. So he's running towards the northeast where the portal was. Okay.
Oh my god.
He's with slug in hand.
Yeah, with the soul in hand. Vork, it's your turn.
Okay, I'm looking for 11 or higher. I got a 2.
Oh, we're all gonna die
next Sunday.
Okay,
we're all gonna die. It's all coming together.
So mark that.
Stabilize us.
Marked it.
Codex.
Okay, I'm doing a saving throw. Ah, 17. I did a save. So I have one save, one fail.
Okay, Blades.
All right, you guys ready for this? I shouldn't have said that. Ah, hey, I got 12. Okay, one success. I'm still kicking, baby. I'm fighting.
Nice. Okay, so then where are we? Blades. Tink.
Okay.
Stabilize Clara.
Can I like telepathically talk to my people like while they're dead or no?
Not while they're dead.
Okay, because I just feel like I really just need to kill Zombu right now because he's like causing a lot of chaos, but okay. I don't want people to be mad at me.
Stabilize.
I can't stabilize if Clara, anybody, right?
You can stabilize Clara. You can stabilize any of us.
Oh, okay, I can?
Will y'all give me 1 second?
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay.
How do you stabilize?
Amy Vorphal needs to do something. She has an immediate
leaving.
Wait.
Really upset her.
She's consulting with someone. I think she's so intense.
I have that effect on people.
I feel like she had 4 D&D books out.
The night.
She's calling an outside professional. She's
surrounded by tomes.
I swear to God, she's calling like a professional, you know, like a DM.
But yes,
she's
if
like,
we don't,
I need a consultant.
It's like we don't your DM or something.
If we don't stabilize Clara in this turn, she's probably going to permadeath.
Also, if Vork fails another one, he'll die.
No, I have 2 more failures.
Oh, you have 2 more failures. Okay.
I only have 1 failure, 1 success.
Same.
Oh, okay.
We all agree that I should save Clara.
You should save
Clara.
Oh, yes. Yes.
I mean, not that we are going to tell
I feel
you
like
what to do on your turn, but you should probably.
I feel like Zabu is like fucking shut up.
Yeah, well, but he's got a lot of HP.
She'll really die. If you stabilize her, she could just sit there as a dead as a body and not die permanently.
Okay.
Just sit there as a body.
Just,
you know, corpse it up.
She's either calling Matt Mercer or Gary.
I don't know if she's calling Gary.
No, I don't think Gary. No,
DMs can phone a friend. That's
phone a friend. It's a phone a friend situation.
Calling in for a consult.
Oh, Chris Perkins is who I was thinking about. The D&D guy. He's great.
I want to just see like all of the online D&D, the pro DM just converge on the screen.
I mean, this one, I think all of them will be pushing some glasses up their nose and be like, well, you know, but. We're crazy. We're hard to wrangle. So.
She's back.
Uh-oh. Did you seance Gary Gygax?
Okay. Gygax.
All right. Chink, what would you like to do?
I've never
Where
seen
did you go,
name?
Amy?
Nowhere. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Don't ask questions.
I'm sorry.
It's me.
Okay. Everyone said that I have to save Clara. So that's what I will stabilize Clara.
Awesome. That's your turn. And you can definitely do that. She's stabilized. I think, Zabu, it's your turn then.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Well, hold on. Tink. Yeah, it is. It's Zabu's turn.
Guys. I'm so sorry. Oh gosh. What am I doing? What am I doing? Oh, my friends. What? Keep going? Oh, but they're my buddies.
Oh no.
Okay, I don't have any charges left. Am I just. Okay. All right. I just can't see it. I can't see this happen. It's going to make me sad. Oh, that's a good idea. All right. Well, I'm going to cast darkness and just let and just let my zombie friends kill my real friends. Okay. Sounds good. Casting darkness.
So
no one can see.
Is this even part of the game? Is this legal?
Is this legal?
This just seems like...
So what happens?
This is what happens when you give your players OP things.
Spreads from a point that I choose, which is the average point between everybody, and 15-foot radius sphere. Darkness spreads around all corners. Creatures with dark vision can't see through the darkness, and non-magical light can't illuminate it.
Okay, yeah, so around...
Nobody can see anything while all those zombie friends come.
Yeah, from what point are you trying, like, what are you trying to make dark? Because you can point it at, it's a 15-foot radius, but you can point it wherever you want it to be dark.
Yeah, so, I mean, just, I want to point it at where a majority of my friends are.
Okay.
Does that make sense? So they can't really see
it. Yeah, I would say since Tink's the only one left alive, it's like Tink versus Jasper at this point. So
put it around Tink.
Yeah, I would put it around Tink to help that happen. So
yeah, why not? That tracks.
I don't want to, but I do kinda.
Yeah. I'm glad it's happening.
Okay, Clara, you're stabilized. You don't need to make any rolls, but you also aren't healed. It's Jasper's turn. He's gonna keep running. Your turn.
Death save. Okay, guys. Come on now.
If it's a 1, buddy.
15.
Hey!
Yep. Awesome. Codex.
Okay, here I go. Rolling. A 1.
That's two. That's two failed saves.
Oh no.
So are you
dead? I'm dead.
Okay, Codex is dead.
Codex has shuffled off the mortal coil.
I'm dead.
You have three failed saves.
I'm not kidding. Dead for good.
It's a one. I have to be honest. I rolled a one.
Permadead. Yeah, that's permadead.
Permadead. Absolutely.
So what? We stop playing. We don't. We're not.
So who's stream? We don't stop playing. No, this was.
Whose stream do we use?
Okay, Codex is dead.
Listen, we're dealing with souls in hell. I'm sure there's a plan.
Yes. Oh, no, we're all going to hell right now is the plan.
Yes. Blades.
Here we go. Wait, who else
is anyone dead, dead?
That's it. Dead Codex has bangs.
Dead Codex has bangs.
Blades, roll.
I got another failure. I'm at two failures.
Okay, Tink, you can stabilize Blades.
But she can't see anything, right? Is she in darkness? Bork.
Try She's and find darkness.
She's in darkness, but that just means she can't see anything. You can move out of the darkness if you want. Like the darkness stays where it is. And it's only a 15-foot radius.
You can go inside the hut.
It wasn't as cool as they wanted it to be.
It's not as powerful. It would be more powerful in a contained space.
Well, are the zombies here eating people at this point?
Not yet. On the next turn, they'll appear. Just so you know, on Zabu's next turn. Okay.
Tink,
okay.
You gotta save Bork. Save our leader.
She doesn't know. She can't know this though. She literally, as a character, can't know this is happening.
Tink, just leave. Just go home.
Yeah, I would like to first of all step out of the darkness.
Yep, you can.
I would. You know what? I don't care what anyone says. Can I please go up to Zombu, and stab him with my long sword.
Absolutely.
Hell yeah.
Use your OP. Oh my God.
What is happening?
Yeah, use the amazing sword.
This took a dark turn.
This escalated.
Brother against brother.
Yes. Everyone's dead anyway. So.
Also, Zombu is undead, so he does take the extra 2d10 radiant damage if you hit.
Great.
You just have to hit.
And so he's a zombie. So don't zombies? You need to like hit him in the head or something, or you have to decapitate them to actually kill them, or
get
him.
Just get him.
In D&D, you just have to hit him.
Okay, got it.
But you can, you can say that you can.
We're all. Him. It's gonna be the Tink show. We're so all gonna
15,
die.
15. I rolled a 15 to hit.
Plus anything don't plus.
To, don't try to dispel the spell or knock the wand out of my hand. Just I guess kill me.
Did you do plus two for your sword?
Well, I want to chop his arms off so like he's not holding the orb anymore.
That's fair. Okay, so you do hit. So roll 3d10. Okay.
What a day.
But what are you actually? Are you gonna kill him or are you gonna
8, 7, so 23.
I woke up feeling good this morning.
23.
I mean, look, if I chop his arms off and then during that time he dies, then that's all it's not my fault.
I think,
you know.
Dabu, did you take any damage from the explosion?
I did, yeah.
Oh, so he's dead. He's down.
Great.
Hold on, because I'm an undead. I'm undead. So there's.
Oh, undead. So he takes even more damage, right, Amy?
Well, that's why you get to do the 2d10 radiant.
But I think that when I get, what's the thing where I go to zero and then I don't go to zero? Right.
Oh God, where did that go? Oh, that's Tink's. Okay, hold on. Yes, there is an undead trait that you have. Mm-hmm. You need to make a constitution saving throw. How much damage did you do, Tink?
But if he's undead, he
had anything?
It's radiant. It's radiant damage though. So he can't save.
Oh, you're
can he?
Right. You have to do a constitution saving throw unless the damage is radiant or from a crit. Literally. That's what it says.
So what happens?
Yeah, you go down.
You're down.
Now my question is, so I go to zero as a zombie?
Yeah.
Cause it's radiant damage.
Hmm. Okay. That sucks. Well, maybe that's good. Do I? I don't get a reaction then either, huh?
Mm-mm. Not on a simple attack. Okay. Unless you have something.
Just Tink.
I have a reaction spell that allows me to.
What's your reaction spell?
Hellish Rebuke. I point my finger on the creature that damaged you is momentarily surrounded by hellish flames. The creature must make a dexterity saving throw. It takes 2d10.
Okay, let's say, on your way out.
You guys just killing each other would be hysterical. I mean,
she cut his hands off. Okay. His fingers should be pointed at him.
Yeah. On your way out, go ahead and do this reaction.
What a freaking shit show.
Yeah, this is really good.
So, my hand flops off and my finger rolls and points at Tink. And,
This is going to be awesome.
So you got to make a dexterity saving throw.
Okay, Tink.
What a nightmare. 15. We're all just killing each other.
Okay.
16?
15.
You do save. So, but you still take some damage.
Yeah, you're going to still take half the damage. So it's 2d10.
Oh my gosh.
All right. Oops. No. I want zero of those.
Please let us all die.
I know.
Hold on. Hold on a second.
I mean, there's a horde of zombies who are about to come in. We're all going to die.
If Zombu dies,
don't you think the spell ends and they wouldn't come anymore?
I rolled a 10, so you take 5 damage.
Okay, I'm not dead.
Wow.
You're not dead. But Zabu, you are down. The wand of Orcus falls from your hands and kind of rolls away. Jasper is out of sight, Tink. So it's just you now.
So what do you do?
Stabilize us, maybe.
Let me stabilize.
I'm totally dead. You cannot stabilize me. You can stabilize Vork or Blades. I am dead.
Vork, then, please.
Yeah,
that's fair.
You can do them both, Vork and then Blades.
Oh, okay, sure. Yeah, come on, rise up.
Well, no, you can't get us up. You can just stabilize us.
Oh, okay. I'll stabilize.
So we're all still on the floor, unconscious.
I mean, I should just run, right? You guys.
I suggested that earlier.
I mean, the zombies, are they still controlled? Are they still going after
Tink? Oh, yeah, so what happened
Tink?
With the zombies? Yeah.
Yeah.
The zombies are, they're actually, so what's crazy about the wand itself is actually where the power is coming from.
Sentient.
It's not necessarily Zabu.
The wand is sentient.
Yeah.
Destroy the wand.
It's impossible. You should see what you have to do to destroy it.
The zombies do close in. There are 25 of them. I'm gonna say they do bring Tink down. Jasper has left and I feel like
this game is rigged.
you took feet.
Yeah, it's rigged in your favor and it worked against you. How do you like
that? We didn't have to fight the guy to begin with, really.
She just wanted them to leave with one of our souls.
This went way off the rails, and then it went even more off the rails. Which just means that I'm gonna come up with something so fun for next time. And this was if this happens. And I put 3 words on a doc, okay? So this happened. This never should have happened.
The guild goes to hell.
Well.
So we're all dead, permadead, because if the zombies came in.
Well, I have to email each one of you about what happens next. We're going to end here. Tink,
tune in next week.
You're down by, I don't know, pawing, mauling zombies.
25 of them. You can't take them on. I'm sorry. You're beautiful. But
yeah, everyone's stabilized, but no one in the town is going to come help you. You're way too tainted. And you, along with Thrashen, basically perish over the...
Oh, Clearcell? Did anybody stabilize Clearcell? Oh, no.
Clearcell has passed on.
Dead too.
Tink, you would have known to do that, though. Yeah, we didn't mention
that. Only Codex has passed on.
So me and Thrashen died, and then everybody else was stabilized, but nobody's there to wake them up or heal them?
Yeah. I mean... hold on. You don't know. That's something. Look, this did go super crazy. So I do need to decide if there are some decisions I have to make. But
okay,
we're gonna play a very different game next time. That's gonna be like really bonkers.
Okay, great. I'm excited.
So this was not bonkers?
This was bonkers. This was bonkers in like a very D&D way of like, whoa, TPK, and I didn't even mean for that to happen. It's just like, well, you have these things going on and juggling. There were lots of different ways definitely this could have gone. You were never, ever, ever supposed to kill the demon. That was not ever going to happen.
So, hey, what a grapple check, right? Fucking RKO out of nowhere.
Yeah, I mean that, yeah. Sometimes I'm like, oh, it's not worth telling you what went wrong, but that went wrong.
Well, I know we're going to have a fun game next week.
Yes.
I know you're going to somehow, I can come back as just a younger, cuter version of myself.
Mm-hmm. With bangs.
Not exactly.
Baby bangs.
So excited to be in your hands once again. So everybody come back next week. We will be streaming at 7 on Sunday, 7 Pacific, 7 to 10. Also, I think we're going to be featured on the front page of Twitch that day. So welcome some randos. And then thank you, Dragonburns Designs, that you gave away that box. And we're so excited to have you again enriching our audience. And thank you, Amy, for literally guiding us through the biggest shit show ever tonight. It's a wonderful welcome back to D&D. And we will see everybody next week.
See you guys.
Bye. Bye, everybody.